evening, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. It is I, Like Mojave, wishing you all the most Saturday of days. Boy, howdy, doing one of those intros cold after fucking 3 weeks no warm-up is very, very normal. I don't know why I made it seem like it's not hard doing what I do. I don't know why I tried to pretend like it was. I think anybody can do this, honestly. In fact, you know what? How about this? Whoever survives the stream today, whoever doesn't die, gets to keep the channel.
Yeah, hey, whoa, are you acting like, I'm trying to kill you guys?
Oh, no, I didn't say you, Bill. You're
Italian and therefore associated with the mob.
I figured that, like, one of us is probably going to pass away this evening. You know, it's very possible.
Yay.
You know, because you never know.
Bill's sending me a YouTube video from a mobster he was casually watching earlier today.
Oh, is that right? Oh, is that right, Bill?
You know, to get tips.
It was Sammy the Bull Gravano did an Italian American pride video. So I wrote in the comments, this sounds like Dago nonsense to me.
Jesus and, fucking Christ.
Hasn't been going well.
Oh, boy. Well, we were going to do another one of these this month, but we had a couple of different scheduling errors, including Dot had to do a big move, had to do a big prep for it. Ironically, we are doing this at the very day that Dot finished moving. Dot's in a new place right now.
Oh, no, I'm not. I moved most of my stuff, but, like, my desk and my bed are still at my current place, so I'm at my old place right now.
The internet
doesn't transfer over until tomorrow.
You're a fucking liar. I was trying to lie. You completely ruined my bit. What the fuck? How can you do this?
Well, I'm not a liar. Is the thing.
Start practicing.
Which Jordan, is crazy because she's Irish.
Jesus Christ, Jordan. Thanks for the 11 months of sub, by the way. How the fuck has it almost been a year that we've been doing shit together?
I don't know. No one's ever been able to put up with me for more than 10 months in a row.
Well, I'll count myself among the first. It's been an honor serving with you, Jordan. Maybe we're made as annoying in Valhalla as we are in life.
Mrs. Obama, it's been an honor.
I'm gonna talk more when I do my Halloween stream. I'm gonna talk more about like what I've been up to. But I want you guys to know I have played Persona 3 Reload, most of it now, on my own time now. So, if Jordan, Dot, and I were collectively annoying about... Oh, Fish, oh my god, 28 months. Yay, Hype Train, oh my god. What a great way to kick things back off. Thank you guys so much. My shit's a little bit loud on the Streamlabs side. How is that? Oh, there it is. Ah, you little scamp. There we go. That's the level that was too high. Keep putting down. If you gift sub, if you like, get a new sub to the channel, you get 3 new months of Nitro. If you want, you can use our funny little soundboard noises wherever you like. That's honestly the best benefit. That's the only reason I fucking have Nitro. Oh well, we're all here. Dot, Jordan, Bill, and Julia are all ready to kick shit off. Yep. Heather could not make it. Heather is off doing actually fun things, like being at a Halloween party. So, you know, good for her. Unfortunately, can't join us. That being said, shall we recap? Shall we get everybody caught up to speed?
We didn't say who we wanted to do recap.
I offered to. I forget who did it last time. I don't want to do it twice in a row, but I mean, I'm oh my god. Ah, fuck, Fish. Thanks for the gift to TLVT. I can take this one.
Actually, why doesn't Bill do it?
I would love to. I'm doing admin right now.
Oh, okay. Go ahead. You
so, someone else, please.
Let me just go 1 second, please.
Thank you.
I think this one warrants a full read. Ah, the story so far. It has been years since the end of the Galactic Civil War. The new Republic struggles to rebuild the galaxy after decades of Imperial rule, or after the Cold War with the Remnant pit to store alignment.
All the while, in the dark corners of the galaxy, organized crime groups compete with each other to gain power in the galactic underworld after the collapse of the Hutt cartel. Now the crew of the transport ship, the Rambler, have been thrust into this gritty, cutthroat world. Last time, the crew of the Rambler survived the ambush with the Glade, which said Hank and Kate provided reinforcements towards the end of the fight. Knowing that their time to catch more Tarek was limited, the crew rushed back to town to try and intercept Walmer Zekas at the grocery store. Zekas had already left, and the crew's efforts to break into his office led to a calamity of failures that nearly saw them arrested, had Janica not been able to get the police called off. Kate was able to trace the Imperial she'd seduced below the brewery, so that was where the crew headed. Slipping into an employees-only section, the crew infiltrated the Imperial base, overpowering and interrogating officers for information and discovering a cache of weapons, as well as the fact that this cell was part of an underground movement awaiting the day, meaning the restoration of the Empire. As the crew entered an observation deck overlooking the base's hangar, a tie containing their quarry blasted off as the commanding officer of the base raged below.
Very good, very good. You are all in the command, like the overlook, looking down at the hangar. The doors high above in the ceiling, very high above, are closing once more. As the TIE shuttle carrying Mod Tarek blasts away to safety. You see the old man from the grocery store, that kind old man, stamping his feet down there. He's shouting, waving his arms, just having a full-on meltdown. Other men kind of come out of a small room off to the side. Kate, you recognize the owner of the speeder dealership among them. And they're trying to, like, calm him down, you know, soothe him, calm him down. Some stormtroopers come down from a Lambda shuttle that was landed on the side there.
Newly landed?
It was there, but it looks, but the ramp had just lowered. Actually, we could just switch over to it, so we'll do that.
Beautiful, beautiful.
So this is what you see.
All right. We are, back here-ish? Like, from the deck?
You're looking at it from...
Okay. Got it. So from up here, we're looking down.
Yeah. And one of these ties is gone. That's part of the map.
Yeah. That's frustrating.
And that black... That black bit in the corner there, that's just like a side room. That's where the speeder dealership guy had come out from.
Uh-huh.
They're all talking right now.
Uh-huh.
And a few moments go by, and they calm the older gentleman down and kind of bring him back into the room, and they shout something at the newly arrived troopers, and they shut the door. And, one of the stormtrooper squads actually moves to stand in front of them.
So, question.
Possible answer.
Are there, like, do we see any, like, turrets, like security turrets in the hangar?
Give me a perception check quick. Let's make it, two difficulty, two purple.
All right, first roll back from break. Fucking goddamn!
Let me check. Oh, wait, hold on. Let me check my talents because I might have
washes like a out. Strain thing to...
Yeah, hold on. I might have.
For chat that washes out to one failure.
Nope. I thought I had gotten another rank in the talent, but I hadn't.
No,
okay, it's a failure.
So Commander Sebi, by the way, pod racing is currently legal in the New Republic. Because the New Republic completely wiped away the Imperial legal code, it by default made pod racing legal again, and there have been attempts to legalize or illegalize it, but they failed mostly because of the progressive and socialist factions in the Galactic Senate. So there you go. Pod racing is legal in the Republic.
Woohoo! Finally.
But yeah, so, Janica, you can't spot anything, really. There's no ceiling, per se, that you would see anything mounted on, because it does go about 30, 40 feet up to where there's a hidden door, obviously, that opens up to the ground, or to the sky. So you don't see any real anywhere turrets could be mounted.
Okay.
You know, what you do see is, what's obvious there, several stormtrooper squads. There is a officer with a gray Imperial uniform that's kind of like got a dusty brown on it, like dust on it.
Would that be this fellow up here?
Yes, it would. Mm-hmm. And he's going over a manifest of supplies that had been offloaded by the stormtroopers.
What is his rank placard say?
This guy's rank placard is a lieutenant.
Hmm.
Okay, so pretty small fry.
Yeah. Pilot or something.
Yeah. And they still have not seen us.
Correct.
All right, we should probably get down there, but I don't like how many stormtroopers there are in there. Would we be able to? We're still in the system because of SAD, so
yes,
would we
yes.
maybe be able to trigger an alarm in like a far part of the facility for some of those squads to clear out?
Yeah, I think you guys can attempt that. It would be a computer check. I'd say 3 difficulty, okay?
Before
all right, Hacker Man, you good with this?
I'm good with this.
Before that all happens, I will say, Janica, you see Burry like kind of like worming her way closer to the transparasteel like windows, looking down at like various troops, especially this guy right here. Her hand kind of twitching closer to her sword.
Hey, Burry.
Yeah.
You want to give me a discipline check, please?
Oh my god, fuck you. Okay.
You did this.
Ah, son of a bitch. Okay. Am I still good at that?
It'll be 3 difficult.
Yeah, Jesus Christ. Shit, no. Fuck. Come on. Burry, don't fuck.
I am nothing if not a trickster.
Burry, don't fuck this up. Fuck! That's a failure in one.
Oh, no. Oh, your fault.
Burry, you are having trouble holding back.
Just
you
remember.
Cannot you cannot hold back.
Remember context. This is all the same day as the assassination attempt and getting kicked out of the grocery store and having the.
Oh, sorry.
And having the mayor or whatever be racist towards her and having to deal with that one Imperial being racist towards her.
Janica notices just reach out like, Burry, don't.
It's gonna take more than your hands. You're gonna take more than your hands to stop this. Not the day I've had.
Okay, I was wondering if I could do a coordination check to like grab at Burry to try and stop her before
she does something she regrets.
He does something
that we're all gonna regret.
Yeah.
Okay, so it would be opposed. Okay.
I'll allow her to make this. What am I? What's the opposition here?
Well, so what we'll do is Kate will roll the difficulty based on your athletics.
Oh no! I just upgraded that. It's 3 yellows and a green.
Yeah. So that would be a 3 red, 1 purple. Check.
Oh.
You're still gonna try?
I'll for assistance. I'm reaching out to her too. So.
All right, you'll get a boost as well.
Yeah.
Fuck! I knew it was gonna be a liability today at some point. Didn't think it happened this soon.
Or he might like throw you off or something and send you flying.
Yeah. Okay,
so.
Okay.
Like if this doesn't work, she could be talked down.
Yeah, I was gonna say you could charm as well,
which Kayvuna is better at. Don't expect to seduce Buri, but like.
Well, I mean, charm is more than just seduction. It's like just making people feel good.
I know. I'm just harkening back to, you know, that one time.
Okay, so would it be against her discipline if it was a charm?
Yeah.
Yeah, I will allow this. My discipline is 2 greens. That is a significantly easier check for both of us.
Yes, so...
The 2 purple.
2 purple?
And a boost, because I'm still helping, right?
One boost. One
B. Okay,
and 1 B. Yeah. That's more like it. 2 success, 3 advantage.
Yeah,
What do you say?
Buri.
She's like,
we've flown off the handle enough times today, don't you think?
She like snaps her head, kind of like gritting her teeth, looks at you, just goes, and just casts like sharp inhale.
You'll get your chance, bud. You just need to even the odds a little first.
If this doesn't do it for me, I'm gonna need a new outlet. I can't keep going into these missions this mad, Janica. This is too much.
We'll find a hunt for you later.
puts the sword away.
Yeah, you feel yourself calming down more, Buri. You're sort of coming back. Bring it back in.
So, Kate's soothing touch.
Yeah, literally. 2 success, 3 advantages. So said, if you want to do that to try to trigger like an alarm at the other end of this large complex.
Mm-hmm.
And go ahead. So that would be computer check with 3 difficulty.
Imagining Sed and Hank just like sat at the computer, just like, what the fuck are the girls doing right now? Nice. 1 success.
Nice.
Okay, yeah. So, said you sit down, you start tapping away at the little Imperial data terminal. A few moments go by, and you see 2 of these squads kind of are quickly ordered by that officer at the shuttle and pointed towards the door. They both head out.
All right, now's our chance.
All right.
So the only way through is that elevator.
All right.
All right, let's get to it.
Fuck yeah. Buri was really, if we could have fucking just leaped down and fucking, plunging attack that one guy.
If this is how we're going to do it, I'm going to let you guys roll your initiative now. Okay? So everyone give me cool rolls.
Okay.
Oh, damn it. That's the one I'm less good at.
Me too. But it's fine.
No, actually, I'm pretty good at it. I just get a boost for vigilance.
Yeah, I'm surprised.
2 successes. Not bad.
Let me get Hanks real quick.
Our boy.
Janica.
Nice.
Alright. 2 6 and 1 success.
Kate went fucking crazy. Kate's cool is nuts. What skill does that go off of again? Cool, that would be...
Oh, damn, yeah, Kate. Holy crap. You might be...
It goes off of presence, which Kate's pretty good at.
You're not at the top, but you're pretty...
Pretty good.
Whoa. And hang... So, all right. So the plan is you're gonna just come out blasting.
Yeah.
I have nothing better than come out blasting. Where do we exit from the elevator?
So the the elevator will come out here.
Got it. Okay.
Oh,
And these are mostly normal-ass stormtroopers. Is there anything special about this guy over here that I was going to plunging attack?
Well, it's a heavy weapons team.
I see. Hmm.
That's it.
Maybe I should have. Maybe I should have plunging attacked that one. All
right. Right, so my plan, basically, is to eliminate these guys as quickly as possible. And move to use the shuttle as cover for us to pick off the others.
All right, so rush the officer and that stormtrooper there.
Yeah.
And also, could someone get inside like one of the TIE fighters or something? And like,
there's not a lot of room, I don't think.
Yeah.
Like, how much room is there, Bill? Because you guys
have about from the ground 40 feet up. Ceiling.
If the other TIE fighter isn't actually there, then someone might have clear shots with the gunnery.
Yeah, just like pop at the gunner seat, you know? That could be something.
I can probably make my way towards the TIE.
Janica does the TIE fighter. Hank, Kate, and Sed could definitely use that cover for shooting, and I can probably draw fire.
Yeah.
Alright.
I'll make a beeline for the TIE fighter then.
Ready? Break!
Alright.
So who's up first?
So, you guys.
Oh, I guess Val's here also. Fuck. Forgot to count for Val.
Oh yeah, I should roll for Val.
Yeah, could you please?
Yes. Hold on.
I totally forgot.
I was in my head. I was already imagining like, oh no, she got cap. Ooh.
Wow, nice.
She got captured by officers or something.
Okay. you guys come out through the elevator into this massive expanse of a hangar, an Imperial shuttle rising up behind you. The officer turns around from what he's doing, letting out a shout. Pure panic erupts. Laser fire begins to blast from those heavy guys up over here.
Oh boy, here we go. Who do we got first?
Sorry.
It's all good. Take your time.
Three.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
I'm not liking that. I'm not liking those noises, Bill. I'm not enjoying that very much.
I rolled two triumphs.
Huh? Fuck!
What happened?
Well, this session's ending early.
What happened?
Alright, okay.
I missed it. What happened?
I rolled two triumphs. So, you didn't get hit, but you won't get the wound, because I also got failures. But
you
crit.
Phew!
A crit. So I still have to roll a crit, though.
Oh boy.
It will be Hank and let's say Val.
Oof.
So Hank gets 36. So increased difficulty of the next check by 1. So that's 36. That's not bad.
And Val,
59.
Oof. Oofa doofa.
Agonizing wound. The target increases the difficulty of all brawn and agility checks by 1.
That's bad. Oh, agility's really bad.
Yeah. But thankfully, the shots, you just kind of take, like, the shrapnel and everything from the shots as they thankfully miss you guys.
Phew!
Next up is Kate, then Val.
All right.
The shuttle, I believe.
Okay.
Is I think that's what you guys said.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, do we want? I think we would want our shooters to go over there for cover at least.
Yeah, right. I'm just worried about any kind of gunnery shot possibly hurting us, or would we be able to hide behind the?
If you guys get behind the shuttle, it'll give them a black die.
Okay.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. There's a reason. Or if you want to, you know, like take some extra strain to get over here, you could hide behind this TIE shuttle as well.
Okay.
It's the same, you know, same thing.
Yep. Which will presumably be the one we're trying to hijack.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna take a run to that area.
Yeah, you can make it in one maneuver.
Shoot at this guy while I do, if I can.
Yeah. So, that'll be. So, frag grenade, I think is that short range?
Oh?
Hold on. It's short range, yeah. Oh. So you don't have to be at engaged. So that's good for that.
Yeah, you can make that distance.
Yeah, but that's also, I think you need to crit to get the blast effect.
Ooh,
And without it, how much damage does it do without the blast effect?
You'll do like damage to just whichever, like if you throw it at the stormtroopers.
Wait, so if it doesn't crit, it's only single target? That's weird.
Well, no, because minions are not like do not act as
right.
One single guy, but blast with blast, would take out say that officer.
I see. Right. I forgot about the whole minions. Shit. Okay.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm wondering if that is as good cover as it appears to be.
Yeah, I mean, there's a landing strut right there. Like, there's two big landing gears, you know.
A fucking turret, it's activating!
That was me, buddy.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I guess I'm just gonna run and shoot at him.
Okay, so if you're doing that, it's going to be, that's going to be one purple, yeah.
And we're gonna have to move Kate accordingly as well.
Yeah, I said one P.
One P.
Oh, that red does not belong there.
None of those belong there.
Yeah, so that evens out to that's three success and two advantage.
It would be two success and
I was trying to get two advantage. Trying to make it so that she only had the blank purple.
Yeah, just re-roll it and then we'll. So 1P.
Yeah, make sure that your sheet doesn't have like the added little the ticks for red and purples. That's more like it.
That's better.
Yeah, baby.
What's your how much damage does your gun do? Okay, please roll a damage. D100 in the chat. So slash roll space D100.
/27
Okay. Oh, that's a discouraging wound.
Wow.
Not bad.
Fuck, that sucks.
Hey.
You get a destiny point, yay.
Let's go, fellas.
I lose one. Okay.
Hmm.
Okay, yeah, you hit the Imperial as you run. He lets out this, like, yelp of pain, almost falling backwards as bolts just slam into him. He's not dead, though. Val next.
Alright, Val's going to, run and join, Kate over here, and she's going to take a shot at the officer as she's running.
Okay, yeah, so that'll be, one purple.
And it's upgraded, and it's upgraded once, because of her crit.
Because of her, two.
Let me see what her range skill is. Brain, 2P. 3 success, 2 threat.
Very good. What does Prone do?
I'm looking that up. It does 7 damage.
Alright. As Val runs, just blasting away as well, this guy, he's like sort of starting to get to his feet, going for his gun. Val blows him away.
Dead. Ooh, nice. Got him!
Oh, great.
Nice.
Alright. Get fucked.
All right, well, we're done. Let's get out of here.
That was a John grocery store, was it?
No. Those guys went into that room in the corner.
Right. Okay. I didn't think so. I was like, wait.
That's why it's fine for us to kill these guys.
Yes.
I mean, it's a room.
Yeah.
You know?
That's why I was ready to start fucking snapping necks. Right, who do we got next?
It's one of the stormtroopers. Yeah, stormtroopers move forward. The ones actually, in particular, that were guarding that door. That's definitely long range. And they start firing. aiming at... They see the Trandoshan and just open up. Okay, that cancels that. Burry, your soak?
6.
Is 6? Okay.
Oh, I see how it is. You're gonna shoot me because I'm a Trandoshan too, aren't you? We'll ask...
Bah! You take 5 wound.
Ah! Fuck. That is...
As some blaster bolts hit.
Youch!
These guys are no longer in the house. So it's now Burry's turn.
Ah, that's about right. Alright, let's see what I got here. Or would it be... Yeah. Just making sure I remember this move correctly. Okay, I'm going to I'm going to take 1 strain to invoke sidestep.
I will
upgrade the difficulty of all incoming ranged attacks by 1. So here we go. Where am I going? All right, and I'm just gonna move ahead as much as I can, right into the line of fire. Gonna draw some fire.
All right.
I was here. What's the farthest I can get out to?
Without
using a strain.
About I'd say not there, but like right there.
So you're a little bit further back.
Right there.
I'm wondering. Do I want to take a strain and actually get in? Wait, hang on. Why does it say I have 6? Yeah, I do. Do I want to actually get in there and start snapping necks?
I mean, it would feel good.
It would feel good. I'm gonna stay right about here though. Make myself an easy little target.
Okay.
They want to come in here. That's their prerogative.
All right. Fair enough. You're not gonna shoot or anything.
Nah. Fuck no.
All right. Well, next up is Hank then.
All right, boy. All right. What you can do.
I will, but not because you asked.
I expected nothing less. Classic Hank.
Hank's gonna do Hank shit and start blasting just like his daddy.
All right, that's gonna be for that distance, 2 purple. Well, who's he shooting at first?
Let's go longer range. We've got a rifle. Let's get a little further out of Burry's range right, here.
So that'll be a 2 purple at this range then.
Fine by me.
Two success, 3 advantages. Gets a crit.
You need the purple.
Oh yeah.
Why the fuck did that not register with the purple?
It was being weird.
I didn't put it in modifiers because I'm a moron.
Didn't happen because you didn't do it.
A regular attack.
One success, one crit.
One success, one advantage.
Advantage. Fuck.
Let's see. The Star Troopers that you hit. Yeah. Hank blows one of them away instantly.
Hashtag just Hank things.
You like to see it. You like to see it.
Alright, Janica, you're next.
Alright, how close can I make it to the tie? Can I make it to here?
Probably get about here. Without using strain. Or more like, yeah.
Can I take a strain and hop in the TIE fighter?
I'll let you do that, but you can't start it off or anything yet.
Okay, I'll just take a strain and
get in. Yeah, that's fine. And yeah, you pop it. So this is it's a TIE shuttle. So
it's not a bomber. Okay.
Yeah. So it's.
I was actually gonna ask that.
Laser cannon. It's still got a laser cannon though.
Yeah. I mean, I don't need to bomb things right now.
Yeah. So you just slide down into the cockpit. That very cold Imperial cockpit.
This is reminding me of when I did fly a TIE fighter in our first TIE bomber in our first campaign. Remember when I did all that terrorism on Ord Mantell?
I know. Okay, Sed, it's your go.
All right, Sed's gonna take a point behind Hank and go for these guys.
All right, so that'll be
we're gonna go 2 purple. Okay.
Oh, baby!
All right, so that literally kills one.
How's Sed shooting better than Hank?
Before I even do the damage, that just blows one away. And 7.
It's Hank's aura. It's like a paladin.
Can we roll an aura check for Hank?
vibe check, please. So, Sed, you just step behind Hank, raising, your pistol, and you just... like, just pull the trigger, the bolt goes past Hank's head, hits a stormtrooper directly in the middle of his forehead, the guy gets blasted back, just instantly gone.
Bird kind of looks back and just gives her, the most shit-eating little wink.
Alright.
She just, mutters to herself, I am not leaving this hangar with a lower kill count than Sid!
Okay.
Winner buys the first round, Burry.
So the stormtroopers The stormtroopers break off, running back to find cover.
Cowards.
They are fascists. And they are going to start shooting at Sed. Well, Hank or Sed, but they want to kill Sed.
Yeah, piece of shit.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, I like that.
Total miss. Oops. And then these guys are going to start shooting at Val.
Does it get a setback?
It does, yeah.
Okay.
And Jesus. Yeah, total mess. Okay. So that puts us back to the top with our good friends, the Heavies.
Oh, fuck.
They're at the back.
Okay.
They are going to be shooting at Hank.
Yeah, understandable.
Can't say I blame him.
No, they're smart. They'd fire at the person who was is about to start up a TIE fighter.
But they're not, because they're fascists.
Oh, wow. That's okay. No, that's a total miss as well.
Hey, hey, hey.
Okay, yeah. The E-Web starts firing, like, towards Hank. They're firing wildly. Totally, this was... You guys caught them, like, so much by surprise. They're just in pure panic mode right now. Ooh. So, back to the top, that means it will be...
Oh. Kate.
Yes, Kate. Yep, Kate, then Val.
Well, let's go, girls.
Dun, 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 dun.
Can I move, like, behind this plane in one?
What do you mean?
Like, can I move...
Like... You could probably get, like, to it under here. That would put you right along the landing strut.
If I did so...
Which guys?
These guys.
Yeah.
You'd be able to, like, shoot under the bulk of the ship, maybe?
Yeah, you absolutely could, yeah.
Nice.
Alright. Alright, so that distance, let's say it'll be 2 purple. Nice, nice. What's that? 8 damage.
Yeah.
Okay, 2 success. Nice.
Yeah, very good. Yeah, you actually do. You hit one of the stormtroopers in the leg. He kind of like drops down. Like his head slams into the ground. He starts like clutching for his weapon. Val.
Dot, you're gonna move Val?
Yeah, hold on.
Yeah, it's a good time.
Val's gonna follow Kate again and shoot at these guys.
Alright, go for it. 2 purple, please.
Is that before the upgrade or after?
3 purple, then.
Okay.
Okay.
Ooh, a success with a lot of threats on it.
Yep.
Hey.
Those are really bad rolls at the green.
Yeah, actually, you know what? That is a lot of threats.
No!
The weapon overheats, so the next turn she won't be able to shoot.
Yeah, that's fair.
Uh-oh.
And it's, let me...
7.
7 damage.
Yep.
Gumbo.
All right, who's next in the order?
Hold on one second. I'm having a tough math moment.
Do your thing. Do your thing.
That's all
right. Perfect. Okay. Yeah. Val killed one of them.
Hey, oh, nice.
Yeah, one of the guys drops. Coincidentally, the guy who just smashed his face into the ground. All right, it's one of the stormtrooper squad's next turn. They start just opening up on Burry.
Alrighty, they all gotta make their shots with one extra difficulty.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
That's a threat, okay. Wait. Okay, that really fucked me up. So I dropped that extra purple in, and it hit the yellow die that had an advantage. And it hit the die and flipped it to a triumph.
What?
And I was literally sitting here going, I'm not crazy, but that was not there a minute ago. Holy shit.
Okay, thank you for noticing that.
No, I was like, that's not right. No, that was a total miss.
God, thank you.
Okay, hurry. It's your go.
All right, nice. Okay. After serpentining her way past all those lasers.
I felt like I was being gaslit by myself or something.
Okay.
Holy shit.
I figured one of these stormtroopers running over here, turns his head around. Burry fucking locks eyes with that one as they're running away, and just, like, fucking moves the fuck in on them. Do I have to take a strain for that, or?
No.
Fuck yes, okay. Then, let's see. How many guys... these guys have taken no damage, right? So that's all five of them?
No, they have been hit. They have been hit.
Oh!
So there is currently... Where are they at? There's currently three.
Okay, three guys here.
Yeah.
I'm going to take a strain to upgrade my melee attack. Wait, hang on. Yeah. Let's go.
No, I'm sorry. There's two guys. I'm sorry.
Only two of them? And that's probably not necessary.
Yeah,
I'm gonna
is two.
Yeah.
These guys are two. These guys are three.
These guys are three? These are the ones that fucking tank instead of shooting. Oh wow, okay. alright, it's like Jesus. How fucking many were there? I'm going to take a strain for sidestep again. Okay. And I'm gonna give him an attack. That's two purple, yeah?
Yes.
Alright, I'm gonna attack him with my sword. Burry draws that thing and gives her a big old swing! Oh my god, that's terrible. What the fuck?
What's your sword do?
Well, it's two success, three threats. That is... 8 total damage. I believe it does 6 by default, add 2 for feral strength.
Yep, yeah, you killed one of them.
Nice. God, that's so disheartening, though. Look at all that.
You just come down with the sword and cleave through his helmet.
Fuck yes. I imagine he, like, locks eyes with Burry, just fucking, like, she just sprints right at him and just wham!
Hey.
All right, Hank definitely sees the heavies in the distance, so he just wants—he's just going to make sure that the coast is clear before they show up.
All right,
Hank's going to fire right on these motherfuckers right here.
All right, so that'll be this distance, 2 purple.
Get fucked. Woo!
Fucking goddamn! Mm. All right, Hank, that's another triumph, baby. With 3 advantages on top of it.
So you get... I'm going to give you the kill, but because you got no successes, no other damage.
That's fine.
You just killed one, you know.
Oh, how terrible.
Oh no, I just killed a stormtrooper. That's it?
Yeah. Now there's 2 left. Janica.
Yeah. Janica's going to get this TIE fighter started.
So, yeah, give me a space piloting check. Let's say 2 purple.
Ship's a ship. I can fly it.
Yeah. Little TIE fighters are a little funky, but that's about it.
3 success.
Very good, yeah. Right, everyone in the... You all in the hangar just hear that familiar... sinking sound of a TIE fighter engine. You know, like lifting off.
I'm gonna lift it off.
Mm-hmm. Get it flying a little bit, turn it right at these heavies and fire.
Yeah, there you go.
All right, so give me a gunnery check, I believe.
Bow, 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 bow.
I need to look up TIE fighter stats.
How many?
It'll be, let's say, I'm gonna make it three. I'm gonna make it three purple just for like the difficulty of you trying to aim in such a small area.
Oh damn! That's four success, but three threats though.
You obliterate the gunnery team. Just utterly obliterate them. There's like the catwalk, there's nothing but melted steel and plastoid and flesh left by the time the smoke clears as the TIE fighters just pew, 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 fires away like that. Said, it's your turn.
Wait, are these guys still here? I thought we obliterated them.
Which ones?
Down here?
No, not yet.
There's one left, I think, right? Oh, yeah, no, there's
two left.
Yeah. That's right.
All
right,
well, what else to do? Let's start blasting.
Yeah, go for it. Two purple.
Two threats.
Okay. Classic said.
Can't all be winners.
That's crazy. All right, the one that is being stared down from Bury.
Mm-hmm.
You know
mm-hmm.
what? Here's what he's gonna do.
Oh boy.
Pulls Greens. A frag grenade out.
Oh.
And he drops it.
All right. Well. Okay, can I do the Bury Major League Soccer special again? Can I flip a destiny point to kick it at the other guys? What I have to roll for that?
I want you to give me a coordination check.
That's not great. Okay, I can do it. I can do that.
It'll be one purple because you're in his face. You see it. You know?
Great. You just. Drops that and right,
so you need
I have one green on coordination. Okay. Here we go. It's basically a coin flip to get this.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah, baby! Success in two all threats. Right. Do I have so to flip gonna, do I have
you're
to
gonna, you're getting away, but with the because of those threats you are gonna take a little splash.
That's fine. That's fine. That's so do I have to
it activate blast.
Ah, fuck! Do I have to, flip a destiny point for that?
Hold on one moment, I just gotta read this. So, you'll take three wound.
Ooh, okay.
That's
fine.
Been sick. You could have been taking 12 wound.
Jesus!
Because that obliterates this guy.
Nice!
Leaving nothing left.
I just kick it, like, right up into his gut and just, like, brace myself for the impact.
Ugh. Yeah, you are blasted. You're blasted a few feet back, Bury. You slide, like, onto the cold metal decking.
she's crossing her wrists up like flesh. Goku.
Yeah, you feel, like, melted, you know, like, your melted reptilian flesh. Just, like, on the back of your head, kind of.
Mm-hmm. Ugh.
Okay, so... Whew. That guy's gone.
Fucking smoked.
Jesus Christ. Okay. You know what? Here's what we're gonna do. Hold on. Yeah. Yeah, this is what we're gonna do. Yeah. as the sound of battle just is erupting through this hangar, there's bodies everywhere, craters in the deck. The surviving stormtroopers lay their weapons down.
Oh, shit. Nice.
They just failed a discipline check.
Alright, collect those weapons, if you like.
Yeah, just start rounding up the dead stormtroopers' rifles. It's kind of like...
Oh, remove their all the stormtroopers' belts, by the way, too, because they have thermal detonators on them.
Yep.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah, you guys are able to. So there are two... There are three stormtroopers left.
Yeah.
All right.
There are three stormtroopers left.
Let's have them, hands on their head, face the wall, and Val will guard them.
Okay, yeah.
Nice. Burry, she's her sword and just kind of like looks back to Sen and just goes like, "All right, you're pay him, Ben."
All right, I was already planning to pay. I budgeted this one.
All right, so I'm gonna stay in the TIE fighter. I'm gonna fly over here, mm-hmm. In front of the entrance to like the bunker.
Yeah.
What do you think? Do you want to hack this door open and have them stare down a TIE fighter?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's just the mechanics. It's just a lock, so really you'll just have to open the panel and force the door open.
Ah, I see.
Right, so do you want to do that with Hank guarding you up?
You got it. Let me just take...
All right, so I'm
gonna do that. Hello, all right, buddy.
What's the check here?
So this will be a mechanics check, two difficulty.
And this would be two. I'm sorry. Exactly what is it I'm doing like in game here?
You're like pulling the panel at the side of the door, you know, like the door panel.
Got it. With the XP I'd stocked up on, I have added an extra specialization for Slicer here. I have the bypass security talent, which would be to remove difficulty from opening locked doors, but that's for the equivalent of a black die. Would I just be removing all difficulty here?
No, that's
literally... there's no black die to speak of, so I just gotta go with it.
Yeah.
Got it, two purple?
Yes.
Dope. Like it matters.
The door slides open. You kind of stick your hand in. You snip some wires and tie them back together, or whatever. And the door slides open. You see these cowering men in civilian garb.
I lower the TIE fighter I use the intercom to say, "Good evening, gentlemen. I invite you to come out with your hands up. You are all under arrest."
The old man is the first to step out. He kind of looks up and spits before marching forward with his, you know, head held high, trying to show some false form of dignity.
This isn't the grocery store guy, is it?
It is, yeah.
Oh, I usher him outside and just go, "Watch where you're spitting. That's a war hero. You should know." Just like fucking winkingly grinning at him for that fucking bullshit he's fed us earlier.
He stops for a second and goes, "Your kind will be dealt with one day more." And starts to, like, you know, like, be head off to where you guys directed them. One by one, each one of these guys who were hiding relatively openly in this Corellian city step out, including the speeder owner dealer, the proud Imperial Guardian. And they look defeated. They do look defeated.
They fucking should.
So you have captured Lieutenant Kobaman of Comp Force, Major Riker Reinhar of Comp Force, Lieutenant Polis Abrakan of the Coalition for Progress. So these are all political guys.
Mm.
And we've taken their weapons too, right?
Yeah, yeah.
I would have disarmed them if it came out.
Maldrak Sunwaktum. He was a lieutenant general on the 501st Legion's general staff.
This bitch, yeah.
Big guy. And then finally, a sergeant in the 501st. That's what you managed to capture.
Nice. So
as you send them off to be guarded.
So is there anything in this little panic room?
No, it's literally a panic room. Quite literally a panic room.
Okay.
All right, fine.
We'll have the shuttle.
Oh yeah, we can.
The shuttle did just get here.
Is there anyone in it?
No. Okay. No one's come out at least.
No, can we check it then?
Yeah, let's check it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so first of all, the shuttle was surrounded by crates near the ramp that's under the cockpit there. There's 15 or 20 crates. About 20 crates.
And I'm gonna land the TIE fighter and go out and check these crates.
Alright. So opening them up, first of all, 10 of these crates are full of Culto canisters, with 10 canisters of Culto in each crate.
Nice.
I toss one to Burry.
Don't mind if I do.
There's also 5 crates of E-11 blaster rifles, 5 crates of fragmentation grenades, and then there's a special container with 2 thermal detonators.
I'm going to get one of those detonators.
Mm-hmm. There's one more.
And I'll grab like two frag grenades.
Yeah. Yeah, there's still 3 frag grenades left for anyone who wants grenades.
You know, I think
the other thermal detonator if no one wants it.
You do that. Go you're gonna throw in shit. I'll take these grenades. I wouldn't mind these grenades.
Yeah, go for it. Take the rest.
Hell yeah.
Mark it down somewhere.
Got it. Alright, is that the shuttle thoroughly looted then?
Well, those were in front of the shuttle. Those had been offloaded.
Okay.
Because I'm still, you know, there's still the fact that the shuttle just got here.
me and Val are gonna keep guarding the prisoners if you guys want to check the shuttle.
Alright. Let's go inside.
As Janica, as you go over, and you guys will probably hear it too, as you walk over to where the Imperials are being, what?
Oh, I just wanted to say, have we contacted any kind of, like, law enforcement?
Not yet.
Okay, do we want to?
I kind of don't.
let's do that after we, check the shuttle. Just in case there's, like, people hiding there that we need to take out.
Okay.
So as you guys walk to the shuttle and as Janica goes to assist Val with just guarding the Imperials, you hear the one who was just a sergeant in the 501st. He was just a stormtrooper. He growls at the other ones. You should have killed yourselves rather than surrender. Bloody pathetic. No wonder we've lost everything. So those of you who go onto the shuttle,
I do holler back at that guy. I think a lot of the Imperials can learn from you. Take it. Let's write that advice down. Pass it around.
He just spits. So the shuttle, like I said, thoroughly everything was loaded off of it. Looks like they were probably getting ready to leave because the computer had been in just like a standby mode. So like the flight computer, everything is on.
Is there a destination plotted?
Let's see. So you'll still need to like access the encrypted data. That would just be a 3 difficulty computer check.
All right, anyone want to tackle that?
Not I.
Computer check, you say?
Yeah, you'll have to do it aboard the shuttle.
There I am. 3 difficulty, you said?
Yeah, so you head aboard into this, you know, very musty. By the way, the air in this thing is very stale. Said, I'm not going to make you roll for this. Because you know ships, right? The minute you smell the air on this thing, you know that the Imperials don't even have the materials. Like, wherever these came from, don't have the materials to keep their air filters.
That's nice.
Good. Yeah, this is very stale, horrible.
All right, I'm going to be making use of my new Codebreaker talent to drop a purple off of this.
Nice, okay, 2 purple. Very good.
All right, nice. 1 success, so, 1 threat.
You're able to get through the encryption very, very quickly as you sit at the pilot's controls. This thing came from Kessel.
Oh,
boy.
Okay, so it's all so these cells are all Central Committee then.
All flight logs before that are deleted. But yeah.
Shame.
All right, Janica approaches the Mr. Grocery, like pointing her gun because she's guarding them.
Yeah.
Yeah, the ironic thing is we weren't after all of you. We just wanted Monteric.
He just scowls at you. He looks furious.
He seemed pretty upset that he ran off. Doesn't seem like he values loyalty at all.
Oh, thanks for this wrist strap.
Don't speak of matters you know nothing about, little girl.
This little girl captured Lusenkia during the Battle of the Coruscant.
Captured you?
So why don't you tell me where Monteric's gone off to? You don't know him anything.
I wish I knew where he was going to, but I don't.
Can I tell if he's lying?
Yeah, give me a perception check. Say 2 purple.
Oh my god!
What?
What in the Everything is blank! What is this?
What the fuck?
How?
Right, escalation.
Okay, that's a bit more lively. What the fuck was that?
What are the odds of that, man?
Chat, I hope you guys can see the little log there. I hope it's not too small for you guys. Like, I feel like I'm insane. that's 2 success, 2 advantage. What in the fuck?
No, you get the idea, you get the sense that he is being genuine, Janica.
Alright.
You get the flight logs? I call over to the shuttle.
Said?
Yeah, got him.
Where's the ship been?
Where has the ship been?
Just came from Kessel, right?
Oh, yeah.
Just came over from Kessel.
Oh, Central Committee boys, then.
I think we got a live one. Well, not so live anymore.
So the Central Committee's been planting Imperials all over the all over Republic space. Is that right?
Looks that way.
He raises his chin, saying nothing.
All right. Does anyone else want to question these guys?
I'd be happy to. One who turned.
Don't rough them up too much.
One second. So, go up to the one who just like turned his nose up at Janica. Yeah, just goes like, "Hey there. Don't mind my partner here. Can just calm down and look into my eyes right here and repeat that thing you said about all of my kind again. And as you do, I want you to picture the face of the last one who said some shit like that today. And imagine what's gonna happen to you if you don't tell me where your other bases are.
Do you think I fear death, you worthless Trandoshan swine?
No one said you had to be in one piece.
One piece?
We're not doing that right now.
Alright, if you want to give me a coercion check...
Yeah,
one moment, because I need to find the stats.
Burry kind of guffaws and just goes like, why don't you look back at the troopers over there that I did? Oh shit, thank you, Moon. Why don't you look back there at all the troopers I did mutilate and wonder if death is the worst thing that's going to happen to you?
Okay, coercion check. This is going to be, Burry, I want you to know this is going to be an opposed check, okay?
Oh boy.
So it's your coercion to his cool.
Uh-huh.
So it's gonna be three reds and a purple.
I am using a destiny point to downgrade one of those reds.
By all means.
Alright, so it's two reds, two purples. I get a boost to my coercion checks. Fuck me. I should have upgraded that before we started this. Here I go! Bullshit. Fuck. God damn it. That's two failures.
He gives you, like, the most snotty, fascistic smile. Like a Nazi who thinks he's gotten away with everything. You know?
Fine. Someone will get it out of you. Yeah, you are leaving this place alive.
I'm going to contact the authorities if nobody else has any questions.
Yeah. So who are you reaching out to exactly?
I think we should contact the party because these people were on this place for a while, and I don't trust that the police didn't know anything about it. Like,
yeah, I. Do I have a contact like within sort of the standing committee or in any of the other party organs like higher up?
I think you reasonably do. Yeah. I was gonna say another option could be the New Republic Intelligence as well.
Yeah, I'm also gonna contact them.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, so like we can say you have a contact, like a mid-level kind of person, who will get this up the chain very quickly.
Yeah, I'm gonna get
the whole corruption situation.
Yeah, I'm gonna get them involved for like immediate like mop up, and like transfer of the prisoners, and like just securing the facility. And then I'm gonna call our New Republic contact to like report on like the situation for like a broader response.
Yeah, so your New Republic contact Captain Olrad. He sounds a little pissed. And he tells you, he says, just remain where you are. We'll be on our way very soon. Just remain there, please.
Whatever you say, man.
Click. Within about an hour of you beginning the, like, you know, reaching out, Carillion People's Armed Police from, like, the Capital District, from Coronet itself, like, the sort of, you know, the higher agencies or whatever, they arrive with shock troops, you know, and begin securing the facilities, securing the prisoners. One of them, with a captain's bars on his collar, approaches, nodding at you all. This is a hell of a haul you people pulled in.
Corruption was rife in Duabagurful.
Yeah, I
You'd
be willing to make a statement. Would you be willing to make a statement? He pulls out a date pad and a stylus.
And I would also like to make a statement on the racism displayed by the chief of police towards my Trandoshan friend here. In addition to the corruption.
Of course, please. We could do that right now. And he takes both of those down and very seriously. He kind of turns. You guys are. He kind of turns and looks around. We knew we were having problems up here in this region, but we didn't realize it was this bad. I wish to say, and the officer he's addressing, Bury.
Yeah.
On behalf of the party, we wholeheartedly condemn everything that has happened, and the people involved will be disciplined most harshly, I can assure you.
If you say so. Apologies accepted and all that. I appreciate this, but how am I gonna know that these folks are gonna be punished so severely if, I don't know. Could you perhaps concede me some level of involvement? I wouldn't mind.
Bert, you're not going to be torturing the police chief.
That ain't up to you, Janica.
Please, miss, we can assure you. On Corellia, we do not take ex-Imperials lightly. That is a known fact. This is an outlier. And I'm sorry about that.
Fine, yep. That'll have to do.
Would you mind giving us a ride back to our ship? So that we can get back to the capital.
Yes, of course. Please follow us, and they take you, one of their repurposed gunships.
By the way, does the Imperial Gunner acknowledge Kate's presence in any way?
He's been glaring at her the whole time.
How dare you!
He's glaring.
He might as well be a speck of dust for how much
attention. And it just makes him even worse. He's like shaking. As you all
had something special, we were going to goon the pictures of Palpatine together. We were going to be fellow gooners. It's not.
Gunship, a red painted Lambda shuttle lands kind of nearby. And you see your contact, the intelligence guy, Captain Olrads, and a Bothan.
Which Bothan?
What's that mean?
Do you know exactly? Do I recognize the Bothan?
No.
Okay.
No. He so has he has colonel's rank on his uniform. Olrads is like so Malcolm, Captain Olrads, he's kind of just like, you were so unsubtle. You were so unsubtle. What were you thinking? I cannot. Oh my. And he just kind of like turns and he marches back to the shuttle. The Bothan kind of turns and watches him go off and then looks at you all. Colonel Bailnox. I'm his boss. I wanted to see you all for myself. And he kind of motions off. He motions off, like, kind of into the snow. He goes, would you walk with me, please, for a moment?
Sure. And in our defense, things kind of just kept escalating.
Bro fucking frowns as they walk outside into the cold.
I accept that, but also, I think you could have handled many things better. That's all we're saying.
Now, undoubtedly.
So you all kind of head off into the snowy forest with them, just through this hard, crunchy snow.
But you know, I was never in intelligence. I was in rogue, and rogue. What mattered was results.
Yes, that's true to a point. But a mission with rogue usually ended with something going boom, right?
Oh, ideally.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean, though.
Yeah.
Look.
I know what you mean.
Look. First things first. You all need to deal with that bounty of yours from Black Sun.
Yes. That's been an issue.
Alright. If you have any ways of reaching out to them, maybe try.
I have,
we know Durga is on Mustafar.
I have a contact he used to run with Black Sun. Reginald Spark, maybe you've heard of him. Information broker operates out of the Chamel sector.
He might be good then. You gotta do that. Second, after you got that all dealt with, and once we get all the data stripped out of this base, we intend to put a stop to the Central Committee of Grand Moffs once and for all. At best, they're a nuisance that can only spread small fires throughout the galaxy. At worst, they're working with the remnant groups to do something big.
Everything that we've dealt with so far, from Bespin to Tatooine, it's always had the Central Committee and or the Iron Triad involved.
Exactly. But either way, when it comes time to take out the Central Committee, we will be calling on your support.
I'll be happy to provide it. And I sort of reach out my hand.
He kind of nods at you all. Besides the little disasters, good work. Your pay will be delivered as usual. And I look forward to working with you all. Get that bounty taken care of.
Right away.
And he heads back to the shuttle. The People's Armed Police, they haven't left yet. They're still waiting by their gunship for you guys.
All right. Let's go join them and get back to the U-wing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, I wonder if that guy's still like polishing it.
Oh, the fucking dick rider at the landing bay.
Yeah, so you take off, and it's a very short ride, like, through these valleys, these beautiful alpine, snow-covered valleys. Landing in the, landing right next to the, to your U-Wing, and that thing is beautifully polished. Looks gorgeous.
That's not the only thing he's polishing. Sorry.
The guy's nowhere to be seen, but it does look very good. He's probably gooning right now.
Of course he is.
It's the number one pastime in Duwapa Gryffal.
they call it the gooning capital of Corellia.
God damn it. I am so ready to leave.
So as you touch down though, basically alongside the U-Wing, in the distance you see more Corellian armed police gunships zooming towards the city center. With and you could see like the shock troopers, like the, you know, the armored security forces, like in the bays getting ready to deploy. So
I as I get into the U-Wing to get it off the ground and back to Corn, I just give a little two-finger salute to the city.
Yeah, you all load up into this thing and give me a base piloting check.
As we take off, Burry flips off the city.
And I'll be right back. I need some water.
Oh, what difficulty for the check?
It's a simple check. So.
Okay.
4, 5 success, 2 advantages.
Yeah, when I say East Pilot, I'm not kidding.
Yeah, Jesus fucking Christ. About as good of piloting as I am at, like, moving large objects and hitting things. Yeah, to say that Burry was out of her element in this place, oh, like, we being subtle is not something she's good at, and Jesus fucking Christ, the compounding fucking microaggressions. Was this all one day, by the way?
Yes.
Yeah, this Jesus. Was all one day.
Oh, yeah, so we're also fucking exhausted, probably.
We got there this morning and did all of this.
it's been like a full, like, 30 hours or something. Yeah, we're, like, we've also got, like, it's gonna be a long fucking Colto bath, both to heal and just to, like, get some fucking sleep.
Yeah, does, Hank and Val have to do anything about their crits?
We'll need to get some healing and some, rest, with Doc and the Colto tank.
We need some
time for the upgrades to finish to the ship anyway, so we'll probably have a few days of downtime.
All right, sorry about that. Wow, great roll. Yeah, you cover the distance in no time at all. You are taking the ships and, like, sublight engines to the limit just to get back to the capital and away from this place ASAP.
Yeah.
Literally, yeah. It's like an hour.
Yeah.
An hour. It's literally like an hour. The U-Wing touches down. Where is...
So we will need some. We'll still need some, a few days for the upgrades to the ship to be completed, which means we have a few days of downtime to heal up and rest and all that.
Hold on, I just gotta get your correct tokens.
Mine's good.
Oh, are they update? Oh, that's awesome. Okay, that's fantastic. Roll 20 is better than I thought it was. For once. Well, almost better.
Big Hank!
Big Hank can't hurt you, Big Hank. All right, yeah, so you touch down at the HTS headquarters building.
Yeah.
Feels good to be home.
And everyone who's got injuries should just go ahead and go see Doc on the ship.
And Burry got fucked up, so
yeah, mm-hmm. we'll need a few days to heal up, which is good because we have a few days to spare.
Yeah.
How many more days will it be for the ship's upgrades? Because it was 9, and then we've had like 2 or 3 days since then.
Something yeah, like you guys that. Got about 5 days left.
Okay.
So
Janica's just gonna stumble into her office.
Yeah. So first of all. Okay, so first of all, Burry, what's your crit situation?
That's a very good question. I've got just 1 critical injury right now. Just an agony.
Is it a 1 difficulty one?
No. It's an agonizing wound from, I think, the assassination. But nothing that's, like, actively affecting me.
Okay, so it's 2, though. 2
difficulty. Yeah. Oh, okay. Oh, I see. Yeah, 2 difficulty.
Yeah. Okay. So, you're gonna go to Doc first, Burry?
Yeah!
Alright, so he is going to... He's gonna first try to work on that crit, that agonizing wound. It requires, like, you know... the use of... scorching pain.
Of course.
Okay. Well, that's great. Okay, so...
I forgot the fucking ferocity that this dude injected stim packs into us that one time.
Alright, so... It leaves a nasty scar...
Ah!
Along the side of your, like, face.
Oof.
Along the right side of your face.
Ooh.
But the crit is gone, so we can just heal that.
All right. And
for some reason, that's weird. Okay, yeah. Now he will do a medicine check.
All right.
Like to just you know, like, heal up some wounds of yours.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, so he's able to restore 2 wound to you. So you're at 7.
Yahoo.
And then he raises the stim pack.
Alright, give it to me!
And just jabs it in.
At least give me like a bite of bite down on or something. Ugh.
You are a big girl. You've got this.
please say something else. How much am I healing for?
That was 5.
Great. So I'm down to 2. And I think I could probably sleep the rest off.
Yes, you can. I'll allow it. That's just residual.
Yeah. Get rid of my strain as well. All right. Woohoo!
He turns and he hands you from like a drawer. It's a piece of like teriyaki chicken on a stick.
Don't mind if I do.
For being so good.
If you gave me a sweet treat, I might kick you. This'll do just fine.
Hank said I need to work on my bedside manner.
Hank said that. How? That's saying a lot, then. Yeah. Burry starts gnawing at the little chicken kebab and heads back to her office. And the moment she's back, she just fucking collapses. Like, not even a second. She's out like a light.
Yeah, just knocked out. All right. So what's the
wound? I'm guessing she can regenerate the rest of the wound.
I can't.
Val's gonna go to Doc as well
Doc just jabs her one stim pack. Oh, and the crit.
Yeah,
what's her crit? Let me see.
I think it's just. I think. I can check.
Crit. It's two. Oh wow, that's two triumphs. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, she's one crit because Hank got a crit as well.
Yeah, and then that'll have to be like a mechanics check.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Crit? Let me double check.
Yeah, let me. I was gonna check as well.
No, I don't have a crit on Hank. There was a small distracted crit on Sed, but I mean distracted.
Yeah, but we should take care of it.
Yes. We should.
So if you want, you'll go to Doc. Hello,
Doc,
big boy.
I can't seem to focus.
Oh, that sounds like you might need some help, big boy. Please.
Sorry, did you say something?
What?
God damn it. Son of a bitch.
Oh, God, wow. 2, 4... 5 successes. Yeah, you are. You have a concussion. And then he offers you as well a meat lollipop.
Oh, a berry snack. Don't mind if I do.
And then just gives you like a little vial of Colto. Take this and go to bed. You've been a very good boy today, sir.
You know what? I needed to hear that.
Oh my god. Of course, and if you ever need to talk to anyone, I also can act as a therapy unit.
I'm going to bed.
Alright, what's everyone else doing?
Janica's going to her office and reading the news before she goes to bed.
Yeah, so there hasn't been much major news besides like all that, you know, like all that talk of remnant fleet movements and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
Really not much has happened
all right
in the last couple days.
All right, in that case, Janica's gonna also collapse.
I don't know. Did Janica know about the hologram Fun World Lando Calrissian news?
No, probably not.
Oh, yeah.
Oh boy.
You do see that. Lando Calrissian is doing a major expansion of hologram Fun World. Doing a permanent galactic fair with pavilions based on various worlds from around the galaxy. He's also announced another expansion to the Hologram Fun World Resort. It'll be a permanent settlement based on his own ideas of urban planning. He calls it the Speculative Conceptual Urbanity of the Future, or SCUF. As part of a general rebranding, the resort will be named Cal World, after Calrissian. Parks to be named Calrissian's Hologram Fun World and Calrissian's Galactic Fair. That is the most major bit of galactic news right now.
I dropped that on Bill Fente without any warning.
Oh,
Jesus Christ.
Didn't you
fucking space Disneyland.
Didn't I drop that on you as you were in a session and you read it out to the other players?
Yeah, it really took me completely by surprise. We also have added, it hasn't happened yet, but there's like a Falun Gong Shen Yun thing happening.
Ah, that's right!
Yeah, right, I remember seeing that.
But yeah, but so besides the hologram fun world expansion, nothing big really happening right now.
All
right.
Well, Seneca's gonna go to bed in that case.
Yeah.
All
okay.
For contact tomorrow.
Yeah. So everyone, if you, Kate, is Kate doing anything?
No.
Okay. So yeah, everyone, you can go to bed. Your strain, if you have any strain, that'll get taken care of. You still gotta repair Hank, but you can do that whenever. Bury, the rest of your health regenerates because
Yay.
You are Grand Ocean.
That's right, bitch.
And you all wake up feeling incredibly sore.
Oh yeah,
it's,
for sure.
It's a tough morning.
Oh. Blah. Ugh. Nasty day that was.
I need a drink.
Oh, fuck.
Daddy, would you like me to get you a whiskey?
Immediately.
Hank goes over to the little cabinet in your office in the HTS building, said, and gets one of the special bottles out. That's one of the 60 credit bottles.
Nice.
I don't know what I need to see Doc for. This is all I needed.
Burry's gonna join said for that drink real fast. If that's she just kinda like looks like kinda timidly between Hank and said and just like seats herself. But like hesitantly reaches for the bottle to pour a glass.
Hank snatches it and starts hissing.
No, Hank doesn't do it.
Or sorry, no, said snatches it and starts hissing.
She's like,
it's like, come on, Daddy, play along.
Be nice, Daddy.
Said, if you don't mind, I kind of. Yesterday really fucking blew.
Yeah, Janica's coming up behind her and then giving her a hug.
Yep. You okay? Thank. Burry just kind of goes like, oh, I don't know if I'm gonna want to take much of that next time. That it's these kind of things that really make me wish there was back in a fucking wasteland. It's easier than having to show your face in public.
Yeah, I know. We're among friends right now, though.
Seth pushes the bottle across the table. I'll share if you do.
Don't mind if I do. Thanks, bud. I wasn't kidding. I really wanted to give that lady you're talking to before we left. Not more than I wanted to get a good night's sleep, honestly, but fuck. I'm gonna need to cool off for a few days. She just like takes a little sip of whiskey. Whew, nice. I don't know if it's a hunt that I need or just to lay low, be alone with my thoughts for a little while. But
I'll let you know when we're ready to move out.
it's things like this that make me wish things like this make me wish you two were from a different planet, you know? We can make our base somewhere that doesn't have so many people with sticks so far up their own ass you can see it down their throats.
Yeah, well. Corellia is Corellia.
Well, I promise I wouldn't get sick of hearing that. Hey, before Janica like goes away to tend to her shit, Burry just like kind of says to her, it's like, hey, I want you to know, I'll put up with this kind of stuff, kind of shit from some folks in the past, older gangs. People didn't treat me with no dignity, and I just walked right in on them. And I thought, you know,
what's stopping me from doing the same here? I mean, what the hell, what do I got going for me right now? But I want you to know, Janica, whether these people like it or not, nothing matters more to me than staying by you. I got your back no matter what, okay? Give us a little fist bump on fist bump on your arm, and I know you got mine too. It hurts a little bit. She put a little bit too much force into that.
And it just smiles through it.
Ow.
Alright, take whatever time you need, and I'll let you know when we need to move.
Thank you. Hey, Hank, I counted, 8 yesterday. How many did you rack up?
I legit don't remember how many. As the voice of Hank.
We were keeping track?
Hold on, I'm counting from the back.
Ah, you didn't count? You lose!
Like 5.
Victory by technicality! The greatest of all!
Okay, you got me.
Alright, and Janica's gonna go back to her office to contact our friend Reginald Spark.
Yeah, that takes no time at all. The hologram, however, doesn't show him. It's like an anonymized kind of like blob. You can hear him, but you can't see him. Well, well, well. How can I help you?
Hey, Spark. You know you owe me a favor because of that incident on Raxus Secundus?
I wish I could pretend I didn't know what you were talking about, but I'm afraid I do.
Yeah, gun guards are nasty. Listen, I've got me and my crew have bounty on our heads from Bat Black Sun.
Yeah, the big one, I know. Durga screams to the sky about it all the time.
Right. any chance you might know how I could make that all go away?
Janica, you know who I represent, right?
That's why I'm asking.
Right, but it will have to be something very unsavory.
How unsavory are we talking?
You cost Durga 776 million credits over that business on Bespin. That's a lot of money.
Right.
One moment. And you kind of hear a click as the audio mutes. A few moments go by. You hear another click.
If you come to Mustafa, the boss will speak with you in person about a special task that can wipe away this unfortunate state in our relationship.
We're going to go to Mustafar to meet Durga the Hutt.
That is what he
boy.
Said. Yes. You know, someone in his position doesn't like to just say certain things out loud over an unsecure connection.
And how do I know this isn't a trap?
Don't, but if our association with each other means anything, I do vouch for him.
Alright. We, we'll be a few days, getting out of Corellia. Our ship is undergoing some upgrades, but tell him we'll be there.
Very good. It's near the old Klegger mining facility on Mustafar. It's right on a cliff there.
Understood.
I look forward to seeing you, Ms. Halcyon.
Oy.
And then there's just a click and silence.
Alright, I'll, Janica's just gonna let the others know. So, I have a way to wipe away our debt with Black Sun. Unfortunately, it does involve doing a job for Dirk of the Hutt.
Well, that's gonna be a little awkward.
Bro, you went off to the woods.
Fuck.
Burry's on the way out. Burry's on the way out. Okay. She had to take a big shit first.
You are in the woods.
It's like something a wizard says to you before you blink and you're in the middle of the woods and you're like, oh god.
You're in the woods.
Some piss of the North Star shit.
You are already in the woods.
Yeah, Dury, you're like, you fine. Just took a shit, you're heading out the door, and you
hear. Yeah, that's a little awkward. But, I mean, not what... Can't say I'm dead uncomfortable with it on principle. Just the proximity of all of certain events.
Well, if it's the only way we can do it, then I don't think we have much choice.
Where are we heading out to?
Mustafar.
Well, that's pleasant. It sounds like it'll at least be something to write home about, that's for sure.
Right. We'll be leaving once the upgrades to the ship are done. I don't think it's wise to keep Durga waiting.
Yeah, so that'll be 4 days.
Do we know if there's any chance of bounty hunters coming after us in that time? Have we given them their word that we'll arrive there?
Yeah, I give them our word. I think it's likely that we'll see any bounty hunters.
That's a relief. All right. Yep, 5 days apiece. I'm going for a walk.
So for these days, we'll just kind of do a very quick. Kind of go over anything you guys want to get done, any shopping you need to do.
Oh yeah, did we get the money from our payment?
Yes, it was a 10,000 credit payment.
Okay.
So, we'll go down the line. So, Kate, is there anything you needed to do? Any shopping? Any?
Yeah, I wanted to look at maybe.
Well, I can't hear you, Julia.
Oh, yeah. I was thinking about maybe some armor, but I'm not quite sure what to get at the moment.
What do you currently have equipped?
I think I have armored clothing.
So that's like what? 2 soak?
It's 1 soak, 1 hard point. So what would...
I mean, like, if you want something with 2 soak, padded armor.
What would doing a hard point on the...
Well, that's just like, getting an upgrade of some kind to that. Yeah. So a hard point is how many upgrades you can perform on an object.
Okay, and what were you saying? Padded armor?
Yeah, padded armor is probably one of the easiest things you can buy. Like, you know, most sort of suppliers have padded armor. So that's 2 soak.
Yeah, I'm gonna get that.
Yeah, so 600 credits, you're able to just grab it from a supplier. Is that it?
so I think I'm good on grenades and stuff.
Okay. Said.
I really did not have anything in mind.
Okay, that's totally fine. If you want, you can repair Hank, though.
Yeah, that's the thing I need to do. Right.
So it'll be one purple. Mechanics check.
Okay. I don't like how whimsical this music is right now. It's ominous.
It's four success.
You clear him. You clear him. Yeah, so while you work on Hank, he kind of tilts his head to look at you. Daddy, I love this time we spend together.
Says just gruffly like, yeah, me too. But he's like very surreptitiously wiping away a tear.
You are a great father, Daddy.
Oh, I don't know about that, but that's sweet of you to say, son.
okay, Burry.
Hi.
What do you want to get done in these 4 days?
God, I can't really think of, like, gear that, or, like, anything that, like, Burry would want to buy. But she probably would, like, spend a lot of her days, like, just kind of, like, getting some air, walking around, like, spending some time by herself. If she's actively, like, around in the office, she, like, probably set up, like, a sandbag. Probably, like, got some, like, training gear, just, like, kind of, like, keeping herself in shape.
Yeah, I was gonna say, maybe if you want, Burry can, like, head into the countryside outside the city and, like, go hunting or something.
I'm not sure about, like, because, like, she might go, like, on, like, one hunt or something if the mood arises, like, maybe towards, like, the last couple of days of their time there. But, like, she kind of just, like, needs to be alone with her thoughts for a little bit.
Yeah.
I will say she'll probably spend, like, a couple of days just, like, kind of, like, getting some air, training back at the office, and, like, tries to see if there's any kind of, like, big guys that she can go find on, like, her last day.
Like, what, just, like, in the
street? Yeah. No. She will probably spend, like, one day hunting.
Okay, if you want, we can do that quick.
Alright.
like looking for the biggest guy. Him just beating the shit out of him.
Alright. I need to fuck up some stranger so badly.
Hey, Trandoshan, you know, my wife's actually Trandoshan.
Get fucked!
Yeah, Burry, so you maybe spend in, like, the last, like, day or two out in the forest outside of Coronet City. You have to go, I mean, it's a couple miles outside the city. And you kind of get to a point deep enough in where you close your eyes and you just listen.
Mm-hmm.
And it is silence. Just the sounds of, like, nature and everything around you. Really, just you.
Yeah, that's more like it. That's more fucking like it.
Yeah. So give me a one difficulty survival check.
All right. Let me get rid of my boosts. Skills and survival. What? Oh, hello. Hello, hello, random triumph. Don't mind if I do.
Yeah, so.
What an odd roll to get that.
That's great, yeah.
Alright.
You pick up almost instantaneously, first the tracks, then the smell, and it's close. A Corellian direwolf. These things are like these massive
big old. Big old boys. All right.
Mm-hmm. You're able to follow the tracks for a couple hundred feet deeper into this forest. You know, cooler weather now. It's starting to be fall on Corellia. Into these beautiful forests, kind of you cross over a cold stream, and give me one more survival check. One purple.
All right. Here I go. Just flat success. Nice.
Wow, fantastic. Yeah.
Don't mind if I do.
You see it in the distance, this big, big wolf-like alien creature. It's currently, like, just eating, tearing some prey apart.
Mmm.
Here's what we're gonna do. What is your brawl?
Oh, my brawl, you say? Two yellows, two greens.
Okay. Do you want to do an opposed brawl check with this thing, and that'll determine how the hunt goes?
You know what? I'm into it. Let's go.
So it'll be two red, two purple.
Okay.
Your brawl is the same as this thing's brawl.
That's... Okay. Nice. All right. Here we go. Two red, two purple, and...
You do have a bunch of destiny points.
Yeah, I do, I do.
Like, I'm not doing this in, like, a... In like the mean DM way.
I gotcha. Give me just 1 second, please. I have to. Okay, okay. Here I go. Okay, that's a success with two threats.
Okay.
Burry. You know what? That's exactly what I could have hoped for.
Burry, you take the wolf down. It is a fierce battle. It takes maybe 10 minutes.
Hell yes.
Brutal hand to paw combat. You come out of it with 4 wound.
All right.
But in the end, you kill this thing.
Nice. I imagine Burry just like fucking leaps out of the bushes and starts wrestling this fucking wolf.
Yeah.
Hell yes. Just like After a big tussle, get like really fucking clawed into, she pins the thing down and snaps its neck, and it's kind of like just... everything goes quiet again, and she's like, "Ooh, that's better," and drags the thing and hoists this thing over her shoulders and just starts carrying it back into town after cleaning it up and
yeah, marches back into the capital city with this thing over her shoulders. Is dripping blood behind her the whole way. Comes back into the office and just...
Hey, guys!
Slams it down on the table in the kitchen.
Anyone mind help me prep dinner?
It would be good evening tonight, I see.
Ah, yes! Janica! Get in here! I've caught our dinner!
What monster did you catch this time, Furry?
Yeah, dire wolf.
Yeah, not bad. You feel yeah.
Like it? Ah, a little better. Bit more myself out there.
Oh, get yourself patched up and we'll get this cooked.
What do you mean patched up? I'm not. Oh, she like looks out of her gut and it's like, oh, got me good there, didn't it?
Go talk to Doc.
Sure, her previous like you know good mood, like her like happy little face immediately like she just grimaces like, all right, fine.
Yeah, Doc literally just jabs you with a stim pack. So that's all. You're back. You'll be back to full. So yeah. The upgrades to the Rambler are ready. You know, everything is good. Everything is good to go.
All right. And if everybody's all ready.
All right.
Did any events happen in the galaxy during the time we were getting ready?
No, nothing big.
All right. Then, it's all... If we're all ready, let's get... loaded into the Rambler.
Yeah. All right, you guys get all up into the Rambler.
All right.
Let's get to the Rambler.
Janica takes her seat in the pilot's chair, and Burry next to her. Burry's just kind of like grinning at Janica the whole time, like kind of arching her eyebrows, just like, "Hey, Janica. Been a few days, hasn't it?"
Yep.
All right, you guys are in the Rambler.
Sebastian, you forgot to get rid of your wounds.
Thank you. As Janica's making preparations to take off, she got a roll, right?
Yeah, it's just the normal simple piloting check.
Okay. 4 success, 1 advantage. So as Janica's charted the course and taking us off, and as we're about to leave atmosphere, she's, you know, focused. Burry's still smiling. Goes over to the dash, flips on the intercom, leads in really close. It's rambling time.
Hey, where are there 2 Janicas?
Hang on. What? There's 1 Janica in the hallway. I don't see the other one.
Go look at the cockpit.
I see you.
I just see the one.
What?
Yeah, I don't see
the one. There's only 1 Janica on my side.
What?
Yeah. Oh, there's 2 Burries. There were 2 Burries also. Do you see the second one next to mine?
Not on my screen, but not on my screen.
That's weird. Hang on. That one. Hey, yeah, I guess just spawned in an extra Burry. And, there we go. That's better.
It's some nonsense on your guys' end.
Why? Wild.
It's so weird. Yeah, so the Rambler lifts off as Burry yells, "It's rambling time."
Yeah, baby.
You blast into space, so give me an astrogation check. It's gonna be 1 purple. For right. Mustafar.
Turtle says, "Yeah, we can only see our own doppelgangers." Of course, obviously.
Wait, did you use your roll or R6?
Right. R6. What's R6's roll?
Yeah, I was gonna say you should use R6's. I'll let you re-roll that.
Yeah.
That's bad. Don't want to get fucking lost. Well, looks like we're gonna have to stop down and repair for a few days on this asteroid here. Oh no, it's a worm again. That's 4 success, 2 threats.
Yeah. You guys set the course for Mustafar, the headquarters of Black Sun. Hit the lever,
boy.
And the blue swirl of hyperspace envelops the ship, and you
leave
Corellia behind. So, it'll take about a day to get there, fortunately.
Just a day? Wow.
Yeah, for all the successes you got, and just where it's located, it's not too bad.
Nice. Not bad.
Yeah, so if there's anything you guys want to do in preparation for when you get there, go ahead. It's up to you.
Danica's just going to go to her cabin, check the news, and scroll a bit before she goes to sleep.
Yeah, there's really not much going on. I imagine everyone else is kind of doing the same.
Kinda, I do want to ask,
yeah.
Would Burry have, like, any, like, I asked this when we did, when we went to Mashuda also, but would Burry have any, like, contact from her by kind of bounty hunting days who might be in Black Sun now that she could, like, call ahead?
I think that's reasonable. Yeah, probably some, like, fellow, you know, like, grizzled old bounty hunter who was cool with her.
Yeah, totally. Like, I just want to, like...
Yeah.
What about Boss?
Yeah,
that's a fascinating question, actually. Would she know if Bosk's whereabouts are known and whether or not he's at Black Sun?
He's not.
Okay.
And she wouldn't know where he is right now.
Great, great, great. Okay.
But he's not. She knows he's not with Black Sun. Noah, you know it. Older Zabrak, female named Resh. You two helped each other on a job like way back when before you joined the rebellion.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just kind of like it went well. So you guys do each other favors now and again.
Good rapport, sure.
You know, she last you heard she was kind of hooking up with Black Sun interest.
Right. All right. Yeah, Burrs is gonna give her a quick call over the hollow. Beep 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 beep.
Yeah. Wasn't expecting to see you.
Hey, Bresh, how you doing? How's it been lately? Keeping yourself out of trouble.
I try.
Hey, don't try too hard.
I imagine this isn't for small talk, though.
Yes and no. What? Can't chat up an old associate? That's because not in the business anymore.
Come on, what do you need?
Hey, getting any rings about me from Black Sun lately? dear, that's not the answer I was hoping for.
Well, up until the other day, a couple days ago, that bounty was all anyone wanted to talk about.
Okay. Well,
heard rumors some big hitters were going to go for it soon.
Yeah, it's not surprising. Me and the gals over here, and said, hey, this new guy, Hank. We were, actually just on our way over to Mustafa, hopefully, clear the hell business up.
Oh-ho.
Yeah. So, if you were hoping you could snag any one of us, I hate to disappoint you.
But I was offered the job. I told them no. I wanted no part in it. For what it's worth.
you know, friends like you in the business are few and far between these days. Really appreciate you.
It's not like it was in the old days. But if they invited you there, they won't kill you. Be careful, though. Watch them.
Yeah. Any folks over there got any kind of sentimentality about Zorba?
Well, Durga won't mind it too much.
That's good.
But in the end, Zorba wasn't really affecting his business much anyways, so.
Yeah, sure. You can never be too careful. Greatly appreciate you. Hey, come by Corellia sometime. I'll buy you a drink. that thing with Bosco told you about that one time. You'll tell me if you learn anything, right?
You know I will.
Appreciate you.
Of course.
I'll give you a ring if we make it out of this one alive.
Please do. I'm very curious.
Later. Good hunting.
You too. And then she cuts it.
Mm.
Yeah. So that makes you feel a little better, Burry, at least.
Yeah. A little bit of anxieties there, but that'll do. Yeah. There's definitely a few folks who like. There's probably like a few bounty hunters she worked with who would like. Have had a bit more like who weren't exactly sympathetic to the Republic or the rebellion and their cause and everything. So like she really wants to make sure like who she's on good terms with. That's all I had in mind for Burry.
That's perfectly okay. Hold on. Okay. Yeah. So. The nav computer begins to blink, telling you it's time to pull out of hyperspace. Janica, you settle back into the cockpit, hit the lever. Stars slide back into place, you see... We had to do that. Okay. There we go, yeah. You see Mustafar, this red ball of lava set against a massive gas giant. There's like some orbital facilities around it. Looks like just like processing stations of some kind. As you take the Rambler towards the planet, the comm panel in the cockpit begins to blink.
And I'll answer it.
This is the Rambler.
Very same.
Very good. We are directing you to land at the new Klegger mining facility. We're sending you the coordinates.
Understood.
And within seconds, you are directed. You get the coordinates, you're directed to the facility. You take the ship down low through the clouds. You see nothing but this endless expanse of lava flows and blackened land. These huge, supermassive volcanoes constantly spewing ash everywhere. The Rambler judders pretty violently as you take her just into this horrible environment. You see this massive lava flow in the distance coming off a huge canyon where there's some sort of like ruined structure at the top of it. Most of it's gone. It looks like it was a pretty tall, like, tower-like fortress. Most of it's knocked down. You actually can see it at the bottom of this lava flow. You take the ship past that and you see this mining facility. It's a large structure that's sort of just built up over the lava flows. It's got this white shielding around it that as you see lava spark against it, it's kind of like flashed and dissipated away. You take the Rambler down and land on this very hostile looking area.
All right. Let's be ready for anything.
Getting a little crispy.
Oh yeah, as the ramp comes down, you all feel the heat just immediately come through. It's like, it's so hot. You see heavily armored guards who approach from a doorway that leads further into the facility. These guys are just like, they're in very, very like full body armor suits with these nasty disruptors in their hands. And they kind of wait for you all to come out of the Rambler, and they open the door and motion inside.
Sort of just nod curtly.
Yeah, so as you follow them, what you see is you are being taken through a working mining and smelting facility. You pass through these industrial areas where Mustafarians, mainly, are slaving away for Black Sun Overseers. It is slavery, you can tell. You pass these large industrial smelting areas where Black Sun Overseers, with electro whips, kind of just go along and kick people in the side to make them work faster, as in these just horribly unsafe conditions. You're taking into Durga's throne room. It's deeper in the facility. It takes a few minutes to get there. Looks like it was a cargo area that was then converted into this place of luxury. He's sitting atop a well-cushioned platform. There is a band playing some very relaxing jizz music. and you can just see all these Black Sun officials and customers, bounty hunters, smugglers, you know, like just all manner of sorts, hanging around near like a large bar that was set up.
How is Kate doing right now? How's Kate? Is Kate having any reaction to what we're watching? As we pass by, like all the workers.
Very much seething. Very much. Barely hanging.
Yeah, that
together.
Should give me a discipline check. Do three. It'll be three purple.
Oh fuck! Not another one.
Discipline?
Yeah.
And what was it again?
Three purple.
I have two green.
You can upgrade.
Well, how many points do we have?
You guys got four light side.
I feel like if she doesn't withstand this, is going to be a big problem, so I'm going to switch a light side.
Yeah, so upgrade.
That is fine with me.
What do you want to do? Alright, so it'll be two purple.
Oh, fuck. That is...
Button advantage.
Okay, so for the advantage, how about this? Burry...
Mm-hmm.
And Janica,
mm-hmm.
Give me perception checks with two purple.
Perception.
Three advantage.
What the fuck? That's wrong. That's wrong. Ignoring those reds, that evens out to a success and a threat.
Okay. Burry, you see that Kate, like, she kind of clenches her fists,
mm-hmm.
and she started to move off towards that area, that, like, industrial area.
Mm-hmm.
So if you, but you see her start to do it.
No
one else has seen anything yet.
Burry's kind of slips away real fast. Kate! Hey. Easy now. It's...
Burry, get out of my way.
What?
I have something to do.
Kate. We've got... I know. We have to wait a little bit longer until we clear this up and we can come back for them. Not with the target we got on our backs right now. But when the time comes... Yeah, and she leans you know, a little bit closer to Kate, like kind of locks eyes. I'll be leading the charge with you.
Kate Buddha's like still very tense, but is no longer making towards the.
Yeah, so kind of the two of you are able. They like they're not super far away, so you guys are able to very quickly catch up.
Just you know. Doing her a good turn after she talked me down earlier.
I love it. But yeah, so you see Durga. He is this massive, massive hut. He's got this like large, black, like birthmark thing going across one side of his face. The music stops and everyone looks at you all as you enter this, quote, throne room.
The crew of the Rambler. The ones who screwed me out of million.
He starts laughing. And, like, everyone kind of very nervously in the room, like, ha 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 ha, until there's, like, the sound of, you know, like, half-hearted laughter and this Utz booming voice.
Please approach. Approach.
Janica steps forward.
Your reputation precedes you all, which is why I think we can come to a deal.
I'll not waste too much of your precious time, Lord Durga.
You are very funny. Very funny indeed.
You
are
done.
Not friends of the Empire, yes?
Not even a little bit.
Not hardly.
We can agree on that, then, yes. The Empire is not good for business. I was always against Prince Shizor's aid to the Empire. Alas, look where it got him. I have associates that were taken by the Empire a long time ago and brought back with them as they retreated away from the core. I would like you to get them out of prison for me.
Do you know where they're being held?
A detention facility on the moon of Yaga Minor.
What do we know about it?
It's in Pentastar territory. It's a major shipyard.
Oof. Want us to go behind enemy lines for you then? As it were.
You do that, and your bounties are taken care of. And I mean all of your bounties. Including the extra ones on your little Bothan friend.
I'll just, like, wave sheepishly.
Oh, this is big, then.
And who are these associates of yours?
Zekka Thine, one of my dealers. This one is familiar, I'm sure. Moff Fleery Voru.
What do I know about that one?
Give me a core world's knowledge check with one purple and a boost.
Ooh,
okay.
Nice.
So the stereotype that all Corellians are like corrupt smugglers?
Yeah.
It came from
Don't
somewhere.
I ever!
Moff Fleery Voru was the governor. The Imperial Governor of the Corellian system. He was responsible for turning a blind eye to smuggling the Corellian system. It turned into a haven for criminal dealings during the Imperial era. He was deposed and arrested for corruption after being framed by Prince Shizor in 7 BBY. This guy was infamous as one of the dirtiest Imperial officials in Corellian space. Infamous for it.
So just those two, then?
Get Malice, one of my old enforcers.
Thank you.
And finally, there is one more. I don't need you to free her, in so much as I need you to kill her. Shalira Desilijek. She betrayed me so long ago and must be dealt with.
That's hot.
She is, yes. One of Jabba's cousins. I understand you are no fan of the Desilijek clan.
That's reasonable to assume.
Burned Zorba the Hutt alive, I hear.
That's not the worst we did to him.
Far more clever than what I wanted to do. Isn't that right?
And he, like, claps his, like, his hand on the back of, like, this Rodian standing next to him. And the guy, like gasps and falls forward.
Ah. So, you do this for me. All of the bounties are gone. And we can start over as associates, huh?
It'll be dangerous, and I can't guarantee that all of them are going to get back alive.
That's fair. But...
But...
I at least want... Thine and Voru.
I'll be sure to prioritize them then.
Malice, he could be disposable.
Do you have coordinates for this facility?
I do. And he motions, and the Rodian kind of clambers back up. He pulls a data pad out and kind of just like, you know, beams it over to yours.
All right, Durga, you've got a deal.
Very good, very good. I wish you all the best luck.
Can I make a perception check to see if I can sense any like ulterior motives or like any funny stuff?
Give me a perception check. Actually, what's your first? Give me a perception check. Actually, we're gonna do something.
The difficulty?
It'll be. It will be versus his god, his cool. So, 3 reds and 2 purples.
Y'all mind if I spend a destiny point to downgrade one of those?
Go for it. I'm into it.
Alright.
Here we go!
So what's the difficulty now? 2 reds and 3 purples?
2 red, 3 purple, yeah.
Alright. Another wash, baby! Oh,
God.
These are the dangerous escalations.
Fuck, no!
He's been acting like a Santa, jolly Santa this whole time. You know, you can't really tell. Give me an underworld check, though, with, let's say... 2 purples. Or, 3 purples. Okay. you've heard about Shalira the Hutt.
Mm-hmm.
She pissed off Black Sun because she wanted to work with the Rebellion.
Mm-hmm. Something to keep in mind.
I see.
Information for you to have.
Yes.
So I think what's appropriate
Are we getting the world map? Yeah, baby.
Oh.
Alright, what are we looking at?
Mustafar is here.
Can you ping that one more time, please? Okay, thank you. Thank you.
You need to get... here.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, there's Yaga Minor, alright.
Yaga Minor is the second most important shipyard that the Remnant has.
Sorry.
Yes.
Alright, if there's nothing else Durga has for us, then we should probably get back to the ship.
Yeah.
And, let the Republic know what we're doing.
Okay, yeah, so you get back to your ship, you know, very quickly take off and just blast away as quick as possible.
Yeah, and I'm gonna hail Republic Intelligence.
Yeah, so instead of Captain Olrad's, Colonel Belnox is the one who appears on the screen.
Colonel.
Status report, please.
Oh, Colonel.
Well, you found a way to get rid of the bounties, but you're probably not going to like what it is.
Oh, boy. What is it?
Durga the Hutt has recruited us directly for a job.
What kind of job?
He wants us to spring some prisoners from a prison facility near Yaga Minor.
Who in particular?
And I gotta give him the list.
Yeah. He looks over the list.
Prif in hell. You know why the Empire put Zekathine away?
Do I?
You can give me an underworld check if you want. Underworld, yeah. 3 purple. Okay.
Ooh, nice.
His particular calling card for the spice he sold is that he cut his glitter stem with the substance used in death sticks. Oof.
Damn.
He's a nasty guy, I know.
Yeah. Yeah, Belnok nods and he goes, Boru, of course. Ket Malice. Oh, Prif. Mass murderer, Dishad. And Shalira the Hutt.
Her once dead.
Puts us in a very tough position.
Which is why I called you.
It's very hard to fake the death of someone like her. And I don't like it.
If I can find a way to pull it off, then I'll do it.
Do that. If you think it's possible, try. If not, she's a ex-Hutt crime lord in the end.
Right.
Good luck.
What, before you go, do you have any intelligence you can give me on what I can expect?
Not much, to be honest. We can give you a little hand, though.
How so?
You're still over Mustafar?
Yeah.
Alright. There's a Republic facility over Eriadu, close by. It's run by intelligence. Stop there. Rendezvous with one of our teams. We'll give you a shuttle. Maybe that'll make it a little easier for you. An Imperial shuttle, clean records.
Got it. We'll get there in right quick.
Very good. May the Force be with you.
And also with you.
God damn it.
Alright.
Every time.
So just give me a simple astrogation check. No purples. Make sure Vortex does it. And as you go to Eriadu to meet with this contact, maybe we take a 10-minute break?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Right on. Alright, y'all. We are going to be...
Let's get that rolled. Fantastic. You're going to get to Eriadu in less than a day.
All right. We're going to be right back. All right, we're back.
All right. So we'll fast forward a teeny bit. The coordinates you were given, you are brought to, like, it's literally like a Republic Special Forces, like, operations black site space station. Like, in Eriadu space.
Mm-hmm.
A Lambda class...
Gotta keep an eye on those fucking Tarkins.
We gotta watch the Germans. a white Lambda shuttle...
Oh!
...comes alongside you guys.
Oh, boy.
And, it does that, like, sideways docking that they do... in Rebels, and it docks from, like, the underside. It has, like, a hatch, so it docks with the side of the Rambler.
Oh dear. Any Republic regalia that we gotta, like, hide really fast?
No, this is
Ariadne is a Republic shuttle. Planet.
Oh, okay.
That's their contact, right?
This is from intelligence. This is
right. Okay. I cross my wires momentarily.
Yes. So,
is there anyone in the shuttle, or is it just remotely piloted?
It was like remotely. It was tractored over.
So. All right. We'll use this for our infiltration then.
Alrighty.
Alright, you guys ready?
Oldest trick in the book. Let's get comfortable.
Alright, so this will require 3 astrogation jumps. So, for the first one, this is going to get you guys from Ariadu here to Ithor. Okay? That's a simple astrogation check.
Alrighty.
Let me pull up R6.
Are we using the exact same model shuttle that they used to... Yes, oh,
Lambda,
fuck!
Lambda shuttle is...
fuck yes.
The same as the...
You think that they'd start, like, you know, phasing these out for doing this trick so frequently?
It's a good shuttle.
It is.
Yeah, it's a workhorse. You can't argue with it. All right, fantastic. You guys are going to make the trip to Ithor in like 2.5 days.
Nice.
So you guys set the coordinates, make the jump to hyperspace, and now it starts to really settle in. You guys are going into the Imperial Remnant.
Oh, baby. Here we go.
You guys got 2 days to think on that.
Yeah, Janica's kind of white knuckling the controls.
Yeah,
because she's going into the Imperial Remnant. That means she has something else on her mind.
Kate Luna spent her entire time in the Rebellion and before that in this exact situation, so she's like going back into work mode.
Yeah, like cleaning your weapons.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. 2 days later, you come out of hyperspace over Ithor. You see that brilliant blue and green planet with, it's like, beautiful. The orbital habitats. It's a jewel in the sky. It really is. You ready for the next astrogation jump into the Pentastar alignment?
Yeah.
4 difficulty.
Oof. Oh, nice. 2 success, 1 threat.
All right. You're now basically off the hyperlanes. You know? You go over the coordinates R6 has inputted. You, like, run them yourself 2 more times just to make sure. And you're reasonably sure you should be good. This... this check... will take you, where is it? Over Karlak. It's not a heavily occupied world. So you guys know you can reasonably settle here on... It's got, like, these abandoned moons around it, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
You make the jump into the Pentastar alignment. The Rambler slips into hyperspace... couple hours later comes out over just a minor world that has never been liberated after everything that's happened. So you guys got 1 more jump to Yaga Minor. What are you doing exactly? Do you have a plan?
So this is a prison, right?
Yeah. There's a prison on the moon of the planet. On the planet's moon.
Okay. I mean, we could do a classic, like, Chewbacca trick where we act like we are... Do we have any, like, gear, like, armor or something that we could pretend to be, like, stormtroopers or something with?
We could say that we commandeered some stormtrooper armor off those guys we killed on Corellia.
We did take their stuff.
That would probably, like, cost a destiny you point, know what? Though, to say that we did that.
If you want to do that with a destiny point, I will say you guys took all the stormtrooper armor and their weapons from them. You stripped them down. Just
we did take their weapons. All right.
Yeah, so you guys have a couple suits of stormtrooper armor.
Wow, that's a lot of dark side on Bill's side. Oh boy.
Yeah.
Thank you for pointing that out.
Oh, I just realized R6 did that.
I was aware.
Good job, R6.
Oh, yeah. R6 a dick. Yeah, I was fully aware. Don't worry, guys.
So do we want to do some kind of trick like that where we
it's probably our best option. Well, unless we can find another way in.
Yeah, like a sneak in, because also doing that might have to like have clearance codes and stuff like that, and we don't really have the information for that at the moment.
That's right.
The best we could do is like have said intercept them somehow, but like that's a little tricky.
I mean, you are in Imperial space now. So like at the very least you can try to do some fuckery with the Imperial Holonet and forge some good credentials.
All right. Let's see if we can.
Yeah, that's probably a good option. It'll be necessary for us to for the Rambler as well, to have something to flash.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It'll be two computer checks to do the two separate kind of false credentials. So for the Imperial ones, to forge those, that's very hard. So it's gonna be a three purple check, and I'm gonna upgrade it.
Ah.
So it'll be two purple and a red.
Oh boy. Okay. Is it time to use those data spikes?
It's gonna have to be.
Yeah, baby. Okay.
What does that do? Does that downgrade it?
It does downgrade it, yes.
Yeah, double check quick. But then that's kind of funny. It'll just go back to three purple.
Three purple I can handle.
Yeah.
Reduces the difficulty by two.
Oh, shit! So it's two purple, then.
Yeah, it'll be two purple.
Nice. Fine by me. Computers check?
Yeah.
Here we go! All right, let's go! Three success.
So you interface with the shuttle's, like, computer system, and you kind of just, like, very easily, especially just now, slice into the Imperial Holonet. Seems like they're using a lot of the same frequencies. So what kind of credentials are you forging for the shuttle?
Ooh.
I guess prisoner transport if we're going to a prison.
Or yeah, I feel like that might have to be it.
Because they might want to put prisoners on our prison transport if we show up as a prison transport.
Yeah, can we... It might be like a prisoner transfer.
Yeah. Or cargo. Like, those are the only two things that would be showing up at this place.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's say prisoner transfer, since the current situation in the alignment has made the facility unsecure for these prisoners.
Okay. Oh, all right. Now all we need to do is figure out who's gonna be the prisoner. Why is everyone looking at me? Come on!
Sounds Ted, like you just volunteered.
So first of all, Set is able to, you are able to forge a beautiful set of credentials, almost flawless. Lambda Shuttle LZ117 for prisoner transfer with the. You know, with the reasons, you know, you provided. So one more computers check. It'll be 3 purple to do a good, you know, convincing forge credentials for the Rambler itself. Okay. You're able to put together some reasonably okay ones, you know, like a quick look over.
Just generic, like merchant marine.
Yeah, like unless there's a particularly paranoid Imperial ship captain, they're gonna give these a once over and that'll be it, you know.
Yeah, let's be real. They're outsourcing this work to begin with.
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. So, but you guys are able to get those credentials together. Yeah.
Nice.
Okay, so that means we're showing up with a fake prisoner. Buries the prisoner. Who's gonna be the guards?
Between
Janica and someone else.
Janica and Sed, probably.
Okay.
What's
stealth like?
Yeah, go ahead and check that.
With regards to the prisoner transfer, I feel like my intention was like we're transferring the prisoners out of the prison.
Ah.
We're here to pick people up.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, then does that mean that we're requesting the specific prisoners that we're trying to escape with?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that was my thinking.
That's not bad.
But like the facility is considered unsecure for these prisoners at this time, and they need to be transferred to a different facility.
Well, then
let's say like near Cantonica.
Okay, so if it's gonna be about like convincing them that we're supposed to be taking these prisoners, should Kate go in case like she needs to like charm and just
I think definitely all of you guys should be.
Oh, we have enough suits for that.
Yeah.
Oh, for some reason I was like we only have 2 suits. Okay,
no,
like,
you guys have enough suits for that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so you're fine there.
Okay.
Will Kate fit into a stormtrooper helmet?
Yeah, she can tie her to Leku.
Yeah.
Sure.
I mean, I doubt she's comfortable.
It'll be very tight, but she could pull it off, yeah.
Yeah. And if it comes to it, I feel like Burry, even in a stormtrooper suit, was gonna fucking stand out, so maybe, under the guise, we're doing a swap. Like, we're bringing in Burry, and...
Well, that doesn't work, because we're going to need to take Burry back.
Oh, we're not going to let me get that far into it, right? Right?
I mean, we can't necessarily control what they do if they think you're a prisoner they're supposed to deal with.
I mean, Burry, maybe Burry should just stay in the shuttle while we go get the... while we collect the prisoners.
That might not be
like,
it. That might have to be it if we do this plan, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so if you guys want, so you'll take the shuttle there. You'll leave R6 with the Rambler or something, I assume.
Right.
All right. So I'll let you use R6 to come aboard the shuttle, though. And input the astrogation stuff into the coordinates. So it'll be a 3 difficulty astrogation. And I am going to upgrade it to a red and 2 purples.
Fuck! Is that our first ever astrogation failure?
Yeah.
Jesus. Yeah, that's not ideal.
You're reasonably sure that it'll be good. The big thing is Yaga Miner is a high security system.
Right.
So hopefully it'll be good.
All right.
You all get aboard the Lambda. R6 does a little, like, circle around you, Janica, and then, like, bumps into your leg and lets out a whistle.
I just pat his dome.
And then he... the shuttle. He whistles, and you guys get into the shuttle. You kind of have to, like, climb in awkwardly because you climb in through a hatch in the floor of the shuttle. Very quickly, you're able to detach. The shuttle breaks away from the Rambler, and you get a glimpse of the of your ship before the wings fold down and you blast off into hyperspace.
Nice.
It's a several hour journey. It's not long. Not long at all.
Mm-hmm.
You come out of hyperspace hard, however.
Blah!
It sounds like there was heavy damage in the entry back into real space.
Ooh.
Look, it sounds like the engine is starting to fail. You can still... You're still good, but it's starting to fail.
Can I make some spot repairs here?
Yeah, you guys can do that. Mechanics check, 3 purple.
Okay.
Success 2. You're able to patch it up for a few hours.
Okay.
So you think you can get a few hours out of it. In the distance, you see Yaga Minor. This massive Imperial docking facility. What you see is hundreds, thousands of ships, almost every type in the Imperial fleet, over the planet. You're all sitting in this shuttle in stormtrooper armor, and you begin to fly towards it all. A Star Destroyer appears out of the darkness in front of you. In the distance, it's coming towards you. There's a creature of some kind painted on the underside of its hull.
Mm. Do I recognize this ship?
Yeah. This is the Chimera. Grand Admiral Palian's flagship. This is Chimera. What is your cargo and destination? You hear over the comm.
I just patched through our credentials.
So, okay, I was gonna say... Do the credentials. Very good. Several moments go by. We've received your credentials, however, there is an increased security situation. You will wait for a boarding team. You see in the distance a Lambda shuttle begins to descend.
Can we hide Burry?
Please.
Yeah. Well, I was gonna say, you guys do have, like, a pretty charismatic person.
Oh, yeah. Kate, you want to take this while we hide Burry?
So what? They're boarding, or I'm trying to stop them to board?
Yeah, they're sending a ship.
Do you want to try and talk our way out of that?
Yeah. Let's try that.
This cabin's pretty small. How are we going to do that? We gotta do this fast.
Can I, is there, like, some paneling I can loosen and get Burry sort of stashed away? Not comfortably, but just, like...
just out of sight, at least.
Check one purple.
A what?
Still thinking about what to say to try and slow them down to...
Yeah. Well, what check was that, Bill?
A mechanic check, one purple.
Oh, fuck yes!
You Jesus rip a Christ. Panel and you shove her into a crawl space.
Oh!
Yeah.
It's fucking fold me up.
Okay, so
with those triumphs, like, she's
hit, well, right.
Yeah.
What should the charm check be?
So what are you gonna be like? Oh, you don't need to...
Trying to be... the only thing... This thing is contaminated, but, like, why would we be on it if it's contaminated?
We
there's radiation leak.
Yeah, because of the engine damage.
Yeah, exactly. Engine damage, radiation leak, not recommended to board until...
Enter at your own risk.
Okay, yeah, so that's going to be... That's going to be a 3 difficulty. Because you're using that engine condition, I'll give you a boost for that as well. Okay. That's real.
So nice. Very good. Use charm. Very good.
3 purple.
3 purple.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna use congenial to suffer a strain to downgrade the charm check.
Okay, so it's 2 purple.
2 purple with a boost. You said?
With a boost.
Suffer a strain.
God damn. Oof.
All right, so yeah, you head over to like the communications panel and you tap on, and that's what you say to them.
Yeah, sorry, I was trying to do strange stuff, but understood, sir. Damage was sustained to the aircraft during land to falling out of hyperspace. There is a radiation leak reading. Please enter at your own risk.
There's a few moments of pause, and suddenly the shuttle in the distance turns around and starts to head back towards the Star Destroyer. Understood. Proceed to your original path of landing. Get that thing repaired.
Understood. Long live the Empire.
Long live the Empire!
As the mic switched off, I just turned to the others, just like, that always works.
Burry kicks the panel out and just goes, didn't even need to hide me, eh? Fuck!
You see in the distance, the Star Destroyer turns slowly. It's like Leviathan in the blackness of a deep ocean. Towards the massive assembly of ships. You see many more now are actually detaching from the dry dock and mooring structures and moving into formation. An armada.
What are they get up to?
You can see it by now, though. The moon sits on the far end of the world, on the dark side of the planet. It's a frozen, barren rock that barely gets any sunlight. The prison flashes you all a signal, giving you clearance to land at, like, the main landing pad.
Alright, Burry, you might want to get back in the crawl space for this one.
Alright, just gonna pull myself up again! Just slots it back in perfectly.
While we're on the way down, would Set be able to forward some documents? About the prisoner transfer.
Yeah, give me another computer's check, Set, with a 3 purple.
Let's give it a shot.
Oh,
guess not.
You forged something. You're not sure if they'll hold up to much scrutiny.
Well,
it's just cardboard and crayon.
Fuck.
I was gonna suggest that. No, Janet is flying. She can't give him assistance.
As you land the shuttle on this one landing pad across this Imperial detention facility, you see that formation of Star Destroyers and all manner of ships all go into hyperspace at once.
Fuck. Huh.
Thousands of ships. You see the landing pad in front of you. It's like a sort of in a pressurized shield. There's a walkway that leads into the administration area of this prison.
Whew. All right.
Give me one moment. I'm just getting everyone.
Yep. So this is what we're dealing with, huh?
Is this the full facility?
We gotta make you guys smaller.
Yeah, big Kate.
Yes.
Wow.
This is it, huh?
They're so tiny.
Itty bitty. It's a big map.
Did I not get everyone?
Me, Burry, and Kate. I'm sorry, Janica, and yeah, just Burry and Janica.
There we go.
Do not change Burry's size, by the way. This is how...
No! Matt Burry.
Enormous Janica.
Big Burry.
So, yeah, you guys,
Oh, yeah, she's gonna be here.
You all enter, you guys can enter the facility.
Very nice that we brought Hank with us.
What do you guys do? Oh yeah, Hank can't come either, I guess. That's true. No, so it's this one, Janica.
Okay.
So did anyone like try and contact us when we...
No, you flashed your set, like it picked
and we
up.
All went good?
It went through Chimera, you know.
Okay. So is there a...
Yeah.
Receptionist area we talked to?
Yeah, well, so here. Yeah, you're able to enter the administration area. It's two levels. So you have like an upper area where they can look at all these screens, holographic screens that go around it in a full 360 degree area with platforms with like various officers down below. This kind of like bloated Imperial in a tight uniform, very like, he looks very British, is really the only way I can describe him in my head, with a big bushy white mustache.
Did the Chimera let you pass?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
He goes, he turns back to look at a screen. He goes,
"We'll get the transfer situated. Do you have your manifest?"
And as he says that, every screen changes to an image of Grand Admiral Palian.
Hmm.
His white Grand Admiral's uniform pristine.
I sort of stand like getting into the role. I like stand at attention.
Yeah. Everyone stops what they're doing to watch. You see these big gold shoulder boards with tassels hanging from his shoulders.
Sons and daughters of the Empire. When our Emperor was taken from us 5 years ago, it drove the galaxy to its knees. And at every turn, the leaders of the Empire failed you. From Amida to Hissa, Zinj to Teradoc. From Isard to Kane. No more, however. We have seen the rebellion encroach on us as we hide behind our borders, with the Legate doing all he can to erase the identity of our Imperial culture, of our Imperial people. Join with us, masses of the true Empire, and take your place in the center of the galaxy once more.
As that happens, the Major who just approached you and asked you that question, you hear him shout for the Empire, and he jumps on top of like a 16-year-old like ensign and just starts to stab him over and over.
Fuck.
As that happens, the stormtroopers in the room begin executing people at their desks. They don't touch you guys. They kill everyone.
What?
There's
the
only
fuck?
A squad of stormtroopers and a couple officers left. He stands up, the major stands up, and he puts the sword away and he goes, we have been waiting for the Empire.
For the Empire.
He looks to the stormtroopers and he goes, make sure all the Kanists are dead. And he nods to you guys and he just hurries off into the prison. The stormtroopers follow with him. You are left in a room full of dead people.
They're dead Imperial, so...
Burry, you could probably hear, like, if you have a comm connection, you can hear, like, you saw, so the speech appeared on the screen in the shuttle.
Mm-hmm.
So you saw that, and then, yeah.
Burry just, like, looks to Hank, just, like, so, like, fucking scared, just like, oh, God. Should we?
Are we gonna see... Hank comes
and goes, Daddy, should we come into the prison?
I think everything's fine here. I think we're with them.
Yeah, the coast is a little more clear than I was expecting.
So as you guys are kind of like taking that in, the screen changes this time. You see a man in a gray uniform with a blue stripe down the middle. Cold blue eyes, graying blonde hair. He's standing on the bridge of a superstar destroyer.
Mm-hmm.
Loyal citizens of the Pentastar Alignment, by now you are all aware of what has happened. Order and security will be reestablished. The people who pull Pelion's strings, Mero and her ilk, wish to see a return to the failures of the past. Sons and daughters of Pentastar, are you not tired of losing? We are strong because we are united, and we are united because we are strong. The Galactic Empire died with the failure of Sheev Palpatine and his dog Vader over Endor. And why did it die? Because it had outlived its purpose. The Empire was created for a time and for a threat that had long vanished into the dustbin of history. It did not adapt. It could not adapt. We are more united than we ever have been, and that is because of Kanism, not because of Sheev Palpatine. We will not surrender, and we will put a stop to this reactionary counter-revolution. This I pledge to you, sons and daughters of Bastion. This I pledge you with my very life. Then the screen switches back to Pelion, and then it just plays that speech again. And the speeches at this point start cutting into each other.
Hell of a time to visit.
A bit of trouble in paradise.
Do we still need to get our prisoners and get out of here?
I mean, that's where we're here.
That's all we need to do.
I mean, we're on official business still, and we've established our pro-Pelion bona fides.
Yeah, so can Sed, like, interface with some computers and find out where our prisoners are?
I mean, I can. Can I?
Yes, you can. Of course you can. Find the nearest computer. You'll need a code cylinder, and thankfully there are a ton of dead Imperials around you.
Yeah.
Yes, you just reach down, you pull the little cylinder out of the guy's front pocket. You jack it in. Give me a computer's check. It'll just be too purple to access the computers being inside.
Okay.
Pat! 5 successes.
Oh, you're able to literally just break into the whole system. You've got full access.
Hacker man.
So, if you zoom all the way out, The high security prisoners, the people you need to break out, are located here.
Oh, on the other side of the facility.
Yeah.
Great.
One moment, I need to go use the bathroom.
Go do this.
Okay. So I think we should just kind of make our way there. Like, in the yeah. Room, like, with everything that's happening, I feel like no one's gonna question our credentials very, very heavily.
This appears to not be a very... No. It appears to be a very Cadus minority facility, so y'all should be fine. I guess Hank and
well, if someone questions us, we can say like we want to get this prisoner transfer done right away, so that we can report back to our posts and fight for the glory of the Empire.
Or we could pretend that, like, the trading of these specific prisoners is, like, in Palian's, like, favor, like, for him, because these prisoners are significant, and we want him to have these prisoners and the...
Yeah. Kane's been trying to, Kane's been trying to get at these prisoners, and we're... moving them to a facility that he can't.
This one comes from the top.
Because Yaga Minor will be on the front lines, and we want to make sure that like these prisoners are just out of his hands.
So fuck.
So the Pentastar line is in a civil war right now.
Oh boy.
Looks like they just broke out into civil war.
Guess we know where that fleet's going. Well,
it's nice when your enemies kill each other for you.
Yeah. Wow, the fascists are in fighting for a change. That's nice.
Oh, fantastic. Okay. So what's the plan, guys?
I think we're just gonna keep moving through the facility.
Yeah,
as
if
nothing's wrong. Like we're doing this prisoner transfer. Like, that's why we're here.
And if anyone asks us, we're going to pretend like these are prisoners that will help the, the one that starts with a P?
Palian.
Yeah, moving these prisoners is to help the Palian cause, to secure them for his influence rather than
Kane's influence. It's important that these prisoners be transferred so Kane can't get at them, because Yagaminer's gonna be on the front lines.
Okay, fantastic.
And we're trying to get this done so we can get back to our posts and fight for the glory of the Empire.
Fantastic. So which way are you guys gonna go?
Well, the prisoners are over here.
This way looks pretty smooth to me.
Yeah. Like, from here to here.
Yeah, it seems like liquid areas would have fewer people in them.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I like going down that big hallway. So, which of the buildings has the...
It's the one right here.
Yeah. Bottom right of the
so
set.
The bottom one?
This one. Yep.
So.
Is music good, Bill?
Oh, why did that shut off? It's annoying.
Yeah. Why did that shut off?
What happened? Oh, and it like kicked me out of the playlist too.
Bizarre.
Literally just alright.
A reasonable music for the amount of fucking executions going on.
Yeah, so as you guys start to push into this place, um nothing but laser fire. That's Oof. All you all hear. However, going that way, you enter, it's literally just a maintenance area.
Okay.
Looks like a lot of, like, troubleshooting for systems is done here, that kind of thing.
Okay. Anything that anyone? Might anything might be useful yeah. in there, or
anything of note, anyone of note?
Well, what I was gonna say. Said, give me a mechanics check. Four purple, please.
Jesus.
Yikes.
Can I make a mechanics check too?
Okay.
Yeah, if you want, Janica.
But one threat.
All right. Well. Said, you step into here, and you hear this hum. Like, you hear the hum of the room, the vibrations at your feet. You realize, like, in the crawl spaces below us is the reactor, like, the power generator for this whole Ooh. Place.
Could do a little sabotage?
Could do some sabotage.
You have to get to it, though.
Might need to focus on getting the prisoners out first.
Yeah, this might be something we do on our way out.
Yeah.
How can we figure out how to get to the generator before we move on, though? Is there anyone here?
Yeah, there's just protocol droids.
For that bastard.
There's protocol droids, and they just ignore you. They're just going about their normal Beep work.
Boop. All right, let's should we figure out where how to get to the reactor? Real quick before we move on.
If you guys want to do that, another mechanics check. Two purple for this one.
What?
Okay, well that's
four advantage. Four advantage.
That's fine.
Then three success.
Yeah, said, there's like a you immediately notice the access hatch. It's right here, and it takes you down into a crawl space where like the reactor, the power, it's a power generator, it's not a reactor, the power generator is housed. You know, it's a big heavy industrial one, so it's literally just removing a panel and then going into the crawl space.
Cool. So I'm sabotaging this motherfucker, right?
Yeah, let's do that on our way out.
Yeah, we don't want to throw this place into chaos.
Not yet, at least.
No, I couldn't imagine what that would be like.
Yeah, we need things to be nice and orderly during this break-in.
Should we head straight for this big building?
Which one?
The central building.
Through that hallway.
Yeah, so if you guys go, so these hallways, they have like they're transparent steel bridges, basically.
Kind of like in Andor.
Yeah, very much so. And so you step onto these bridges, as you step onto these bridges, you can see above you Yaga Minor itself, this brilliant blue planet with the now mostly empty gantries. As you get onto this bridge as well, looking far to the left, you can see your shuttle, and you can see another one of those bridges connecting the administration level to another area. And you see some stormtroopers gun down a few other stormtroopers and just... It's just pure chaos. It takes you no time at all as a group to rush into the main detention area. Prisoners are roaring, slamming hands against force field doors, as the Imperial guards slaughter each other. You really can't tell which side is which. They are so intent. Yeah, and so all you guys are there? Or you, Sed, and Kate?
I do have something to ask. Because, like, these are Imperial prisoners, so who's to say there's not, like, decent, you know?
Yeah, that is true.
Yeah, we don't like, just have to get the guys.
And stuff like that. So, could we just do a massive open the doors when we leave instead of blow the place up when we leave and just let the prisoners deal with the guards themselves?
That's actually
one way
exactly
out.
That's exactly
one that's way out.
All
right. That was exactly my thought. Because it's not a reactor, right? It's a power generator. Which means if we sabotage it, it's not going to blow everything up. It's just going to shut everything down.
Exactly.
Besides, like, essential systems, which means all the cages will unlock.
Mm-hmm. Are you guys communicating this plan to Burry and Hank, by the way?
Yeah, they have little comms, don't they?
Yeah, we have them on comms.
I don't know.
Well, y'all. I mean, I don't know how much you'll need either of these two. It sounds like this might go pretty clean, but in case you need either of the heavies on standby.
Yeah, we'll keep you in reserve.
Fuck yeah.
You guys can come up from the back if anything goes wrong.
Right.
All right. So you guys cross the Transparisteel Bridge to the high security block. The first thing you notice, hard not to, the door is still sealed. It's not open like everything else has been opened. There's like a little security camera you have to go up to.
All right, I'll go up to that then.
What is your business?
Prisoner transfer.
Let's see your credentials.
I give them to him.
Few moments pass, door slides open. So you all walk onto this catwalk in this circular high security area. Now, what's different about this? So the doors of the cells are force fields. There's also windows for these cells that look out onto the barren landscape of the moon. These windows are force fields as well.
Oh.
So if the prisoners get uppity.
Yeah. You already, the first thing you notice in this cell here. Oh, I clicked on the stream.
Oops.
In this cell here.
Yeah.
You see the hut. You see that hut.
Oh.
The officer at the council waits for you all to enter and then shuts the door and locks it again, and he goes, I'm not gonna let this madness let these bloody prisoners escape.
It is not an escape.
Admirable.
Between the porters to transfer them.
He's talking about our prisoners or, like, the prisoners, like, in general at the prison?
Well, the high security prisoners.
Sorry. I understand.
Yeah.
It's admirable that you're still taking your work seriously in light of everything.
Ugh. Bloody politics. So which ones are you here to pick up?
I hand him the manifest. The list.
Kind of looks over them. Right, I'll get them processed and ready to go. And he kind of turns his back to you guys and he walks over to the computer. He begins to unlock the cells in particular. As each cell unlocks, you see the prisoners are shackled, so they can't move anyways. And one by one, Zekathine first, the Twi'lek, the spice dealer. This burly, huge blue Twi'lek. He's missing an eye.
Oof.
No cybernetic. He's just missing an eye. And part of his Leku is carved out.
You see Flary Voru, the former governor of Corellia, a kind-looking old man. He's kind of walks a little hunched. Offers you all a smile. Then you see Ket Malice, a Dishad, a well-known mass murderer.
Ooh.
And finally, Shalira the Hutt's cell opens up. She slithers out once she's able to. Says nothing to you all. And they all wait for their orders.
Moving, prisoners.
They nod and begin to follow into step with you all. So you guys make for...
If nobody's stopping us, we're gonna make our way out of here.
Yeah, no one stops you guys. The battle is so thick by now. It's still going on in the detention area. Prisoners are now trying their hardest to, like, break down the force fields, and it's just not happening.
I just glance at Sid and, like, why don't we give them a little helping hand?
Were there any other high security folks besides the ones that we just pulled out?
Yeah, there were five other high security prisoners, just various beings.
Mm. Were there any like notable that I might be aware of?
No, not in high security.
If y'all trip the path.
What were you saying?
I was gonna say because if y'all trip the power and the force field windows go, the moon has no atmosphere, right?
Correct.
Yeah.
So yeah, they're going to die.
So that's why we could trip like maybe said could hack the security system specifically and just like shut down all the inner doors.
Yeah, we still have access to We do still have access to the systems in the administration area.
Oh, yeah.
Like, maybe we could just shut down all the force fields on the inner doors instead of cutting the power to all the doors.
Yeah.
Get those prisoners out, then cut the power, then skedaddle. All
right, so
if we cut the power,
the high security goes regardless.
And the Imperial officer is going to die, too. Is the thing.
That's positive.
I mean, I think he's Yay. Gonna...
I mean, him against five high security prisoners, I don't... Well, they're all shackled.
But still, I don't know. That's a lot of kicks if they get you down.
Yeah. I don't see that going well for him.
I mean, you know, they all might die, he might kill them, but at least we didn't damn them to death if by just letting the atmosphere take them.
Yeah.
Or do you want to just disable all security? Or do you want to?
You guys,
want
to go? If you want to do that through the computer terminal system, it'll be a 4 difficulty computer check.
Okay, that's fine.
And actually, I'm gonna upgrade it so it'll be 3 purples and a red.
Okay.
That's still fine because I'm going to engage my electromagnetic pulse disruptor and add 2 boost die to this.
Oh, yes.
Very cool. Okay.
Let's go.
So that's going to be 2 blue, 3 purple, 1 red.
Correct.
Plus pewters. 3 advantages.
Three
advantages. No success.
All right, you know, with 3 advantages, I'll give it to you.
Yes,
you're able to. So, were you trying to do just high security or the whole facility as a whole?
Let's do the whole thing.
Whole damn thing.
All right.
Fuck this place.
You see on the security cameras, all the force fields just collapse at once. Prisoners.
We should probably head to the ship pretty fast after this.
Let's get out to the shuttle.
Prisoners begin to storm out. You all hurry back to the shuttle. They say the prisoners with you look a little confused.
I just hold my my finger.
Yeah,
up to
we
the,
all just hold our rifles a little higher.
I like hold my finger up to the like mouth plates etched into the stormtrooper helmet.
They follow you though silently, back to the shuttle. You all get aboard the shuttle.
Okay, so we're in the shuttle. Can we leave now?
I don't like this pause. Yeah.
No, I'm waiting for what you guys want to do.
Yeah, I think we should I think
time to hit it.
All right. Yeah. So, give me a space piloting check one difficulty. Great.
Three success. Four advantages.
You lift the shuttle fast off of the surface of the moon, blasting into space. You hear the hut in the back going, "Where are you taking us?"
I take off my helmet. Home.
Burry kicks out the panel. Yeah, this was a riot, wasn't it?
Well, it's about to be.
Yeah, nice.
So what are you guys doing with the hut?
I figure we're keeping her alive for at least a little bit.
Is there a way we can hand her over to Republic Intelligence and ask them? I know he said it would be hard to fake her death, but maybe they could fake her death?
I that seems positive to me.
She is a slave-holding hut, so I don't think...
Oh, is she now?
Very... Well, I mean, aren't all huts? Like, isn't that kind of their thing? That's what I had always assumed.
Yeah.
I mean, if she's in with Jabba back in the day, I mean...
Yeah, it's not. That's not an unfair assumption.
Yeah. She wanted to work with the
rebellion,
but, like...
If she offered her help to the rebellion, it was probably she could see the writing on the wall, or...
She saw
the Empire was already hooked up with other huts, and this was her only way of trying to gain favor with someone.
Or she saw profit.
Yeah, she saw profit. So it's like, it's not like she's a war hero we're asking to kill here.
Well,
but it would be nice if the Republic could fake her death and...
Yeah.
I mean, we literally could say, like if he wants a body, he could be like, we got there in the middle of a civil war starting, like... Shots were firing, things were crazy, people were killing
each other. We had to get out!
She got killed on the way out!
Well, the other prisoners will know the truth, though.
Yeah,
and they'll be hanging out with him.
That doesn't mean, are we all, like, chit-chatting together in his throne room, or are they, like... I mean, I guess they're his friend.
Well, if it comes up in conversation...
Yeah...
They are not going to... I mean, they have no motivation to back us
up. No, yeah, I forgot.
They barely know us. Yeah, yeah.
They're fucking scumbags.
Okay.
I don't know if we have a...
So then it's we... quote-unquote kill her... give her to the Republic... and they can fake her death and then... give the... Like they just saw her, like us just take her away, and then the news comes out that she's dead. Like, I don't know if that's something that we could pull off.
Well, these guys have seen you bring her on board the shuttle so far.
Yeah. So.
Is there rooms in the shuttle? Can we separate?
No, there's
them?
There's.
It's a very small cabin. Yeah.
There's a cockpit, and then there's like a seating area. And that's it.
We're basically on a bus.
If we stay silent until we get to the Rambler, we could have privacy to talk about and do stuff on the Rambler where the prisoners couldn't see or hear us. But again, like, how do we separate her from them in a way that makes them think she died?
We could house the other prisoners in one of the airlocks and the hut in the other.
Okay.
And then pretend to jettison the airlock.
Yeah, we could make them think that we ejected her into space.
Some kind of big piece of something to... I don't know how you fake a dead body floating in the air.
Well, they don't. Well, they're not going to see it.
Yeah, they're going to be facing the other way. And besides, it's... Yeah, it's not like they'll be like looking out the window for that long. We'll be out of there. Momentarily. Okay. Yeah. That's probably the best one we got.
That's the only thing I can pick up.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we just actually kill her.
So what happens after that? She stays in the airlock, and we transfer them to the other
our contacts.
Rambler when we meet back up with it.
Well, no. We go onto the Rambler. We house. The shuttle doesn't have airlocks.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Okay, so then... What, the airlock stays closed until we...
Until we hand off the hut.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's probably the best we got.
The other prisoners are in their airlock, so they can't see...
Right.
...her being taken out when that happens.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we'll say, like, we're making a stop, it would fit if they ask, we'll say we're making a stop at Ariadu to return the shuttle.
Prisoners don't get to ask questions.
Yeah.
Alright. Okay. So, is that the plan we're going with?
I suppose so. It's probably the best we got.
Alright. Okay. In that case, let's get back to the Rambler.
Alright, you... Give me an astrogation check. One purple, please. Very good.
Three successes. You
rendezvous with the Rambler in a couple hours. It's not very long at all. As you all dock with it and feel the shuttle shudder a little bit, just... The relief is palpable. So you put the Black Sun people in one airlock and the hut in the other?
Yeah, okay. And...
They all look very... The old man is looking... He looks very, like, shrewd at you guys for a minute before he looks at the hut.
You want to share berth with the hut?
Oh, not at all.
Right. Well, get cozy, because you're going to be there until we get back to Mustafar to hand you over to Jurga.
He says nothing, simply smiling.
Mm-hmm.
And I...
All right, so time to get out of Pentastar space?
Yeah. But for first, why don't we fake the hut's death?
So how are you gonna do this?
Well, let's. Yeah, we should probably like tell her what the plan is. And be like.
All right, so you go over to the airlock.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like. We need you to make absolutely no noise for the rest of this voyage.
You don't want us to have to pull you out in front of the other prisoners and kill you in front of them.
Like, let me be very clear, like, you need to be completely silent. You need to be fine with going out without meals and water for the voyage. Because as far as the others know, this airlock is going to be empty in a second.
There's a long pause. She says nothing, and then just nods.
And I dent the glass on the airlock, so no one can see through it.
Nice.
Okay.
And then
yes, you kind of stand in.
Yeah, I'll fake the airlock going off.
Okay, give me a mechanic check, like one purple, to make it like you kind of rig the alarm to go off and everything.
And I have like a steam piston go off or something.
Yeah.
To imitate the noise.
Yeah, perfect. As far as them, like to them, it did look like the airlock went off. Opened up, you know.
And I just like make a show of saying like Durga sends his regards before I do it.
Several hours go by and you rendezvous so you're gonna rendezvous at Ariadu first, right?
Right.
Yeah, so give me one more astrogation check.
Yeah, and I'm going to I'll let them know ahead of time to discreetly retrieve the hut. Yeah.
Okay, so give me astrogation check, three purple please.
Alright, I'm going to pull R6 out for that.
Three success, right. Two threats.
So, for the sake of brevity, you are able to rendezvous at Ariadu within a few days with the Republic. They don't look super pleased about having to do this for this hut, but they do. You make your way back to Mustafar. It feels like the last 2 days, or the last like 3 days, has been a blur of just craziness.
Yeah, fuck.
What's going on?
What we just saw break out in the Pentastar, like, we tell them about that? Or they were known for days?
They would have heard, I bet.
When you signaled them before you returned to Ariadu, they seemed like they weren't surprised, like they were aware this was already happening.
Okay.
Yeah, they probably want us to like give like our account of what happened though to intelligence.
Mm-hmm.
And Janik will like work on that report as we make our way back to Mustafar.
Yeah. You arrive at Mustafar. The Rambler lands. And the guards approach and ask you to come see the boss.
And I bring our guests with us.
Fantastic. You head deep into this mining facility once again.
Mm-hmm.
Past everything you saw the first time. Durga's waiting, and he lets out the loudest belly laugh when he sees you enter with his allies. Dancers come and grab them and drag them over and begin to ply them with drinks and food. And Durga bids you all to come closer.
All right. Tell me how that slime died, please.
That slime is currently frosty, floating in Pentastar space.
Okay. That's gonna be a opposed check.
Ooh, baby. Can the rest of us give...
Hold on. Dorothy has options.
Yeah.
So, it'll either be three reds and two purples, or you can roll a force die.
I'm sorry. Hello?
That's too light.
Sub
Danica, with all your being, you know that you, none of you guys can probably pull one over on a hut like this. Realizing, you know, only really when you got there. With all of your being, though, you kind of, like, feel yourself just force. You're able to completely break through his kind of defenses.
And I feel, some, I feel something were. Stirring within.
What do you say? What do you say to the hut?
You'll be pleased to know that that pile of slime, as you call her, is currently floating, frosty, and pendant our space. I watched her bloat and burst myself.
And it's not that this is like a mind trick per se, but whatever stirred in you gave you kind of this self-assurance enough to get through that sort of classic hut, you know, looking for the weakness. He watches you for a moment, then he laughs very loudly.
Ah! Good. I only wish I could have been the one to do it. Well, a deal is a deal, is it not? Please,
is it not?
Enjoy any food. Enjoy the food, enjoy the dancers, enjoy the drink. On me, please. I must go gloat now.
And he slides off the platform. Heads off into a back area.
I'm feeling kind of woozy. Like, I feel something inside of me.
Yeah, you take 6 strain.
Fuck.
I take 5 strain, actually.
Oh, because you have a thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
And as you all kind of come back from that and start to head out, I think that's where we can end it for tonight.
Oh, boy.
You guys will get 15 XP.
Nice.
All right. Not bad.
Good job, everyone.
So, Burry has questions about this. But,
well, I'm not sure it's something that everyone, like, noticed quite, like, maybe they felt something, but, like, it's not...
I'll say that Janica looking like she's about to fucking collapse on the way back is gonna tip her off. But, yeah. Jesus! Well, that was a pretty dense, first session back. Jesus.
You had a lot to get done.
That was a good one. That was a real good one. Thanks for that, Bill.
Yeah, no, I'm glad everyone enjoyed it, and I'm glad, hopefully... Awesome, thank you, and I hope people enjoyed watching it.
I am shocked.
The Imperial Civil War has begun.
I'm shocked how well that mission to the prison went.
Totally.
I know.
Oof. I'll have us give a quick little, like, post-session chat. I'll cap us at, like, 10 minutes, though, because, like, I have to go to bed immediately when we're done, and
yeah, I should probably get to bed pretty
quick. Yeah, it is late here.
Yeah.
I was going to say, maybe we could even save it for the next one, you know, and, like, since we won't be as late as...
Yeah.
It is late for everyone, you know.
Yeah.
Turtle says, very awesome session back. Yeah, that was. I was really, really looking forward to this one. Yeah, Bill, very, very nice. Really loved the ending to the little, to that Manhunt arc. That was cool. He's still out there.
Really glad you guys
Monteric is still out there.
Yeah. I know, you guys got some big fish, but, like, the fish is still out there.
Yeah.
And I will be going in later and wiping the bounty obligation from all of your guys' sheets.
Let's go.
Woohoo! Oh, my God. It's going to be so nice, like, being able to go more than two sessions without getting fucking attacked by bounty hunters.
Well, I really liked it because it was like KOTOR, where if you play KOTOR, you'll just be in an area, and you'll turn a corner, and there will just be bounty hunters there, inexplicably. Yeah. Like, you could be in the middle of the desert, and they'll just find you. And yeah. I really liked the bounty thing, because it literally was that. Like, the ones in Echo Base.
Yeah.
Like, how the fuck do they track? Like how do they fucking track you? I don't know.
They're bounty hunters.
They're bounty hunters. I don't know.
They hunt you.
Yeah, well, they're hunting you, and you got a bounty.
I mean, maybe we could have kept the bounty going for just a little bit longer, so we could have got one more assassin droid.
I was kind of holding out for like a boss versus Spurry fight.
I mean, who knows? Who knows?
We could let's not act like bounties are off the table forever now or something.
cause like
I doubt it's gonna be long before we piss someone else off.
Yeah, I didn't fucking plant those seeds with Bosk the session just for that to not happen. Like, it's we'll do plenty more crimes and probably run into Blackson a couple more times.
Right, exactly.
Oh, awesome. Boy.
Well, yeah, I'm gonna start getting ready to get off. So, great game, guys.
Seriously. Hang on. Bill, can you just say that last sentence one more time, please?
Oh, come on. No, can we not?
What?
Just that last thing that you said. Just say it exactly the same way.
What did I say? I am very tired. So I can't even play
a lot. I know what Mojave's trying to do right now. Don't give in to this.
I want to give in, though.
You were about to get off.
Oh, I'm going to goon.
So next session
I am a proud Imperial Gooner.
Next session is the 9th, correct?
November 9th?
Yeah, assuming nothing happens, correct.
Yes, right? Yes.
Well, good thing nothing is happening at all in the world between now and November 9th.
Yay. I will say, for those of y'all still watching, thank you so much. This isn't like the official Lake Mojave return backstream. That is going to be on Halloween night. There will be another stream the next day. I want to get a drunk Hades in. And then after that, you can join me, Dot, Jordan, Brett, and maybe a few others for a special election day coverage stream. Not only will we be like, you know, keeping up with things, like giving y'all like up-to-date news and stuff, have our ears to the ground, but we have a bunch of fun little segments and games planned to keep it entertaining. It's gonna be a really fun time. We've been playing this for fucking months, actually.
When the second Trump coup happens, you guys are gonna be there doing coverage. It's
boots on the ground.
Boots on the fucking ground.
Yeah, we're gonna send Jordan to Washington.
What?
That's right.
Hey, good night, everybody.
Good night, everyone.
We will see you all for.
Turn that down. You know, I used to live there.
Yeah, that's right. Anyway,
Lori lives in Washington.
Let me see who else is live right now. I can raid you guys out to somebody. Let's see.
I love that y'all have been planning that election thing for months, and even though I'm participating, I still have no clue what my role is supposed to be.
we'll do a run.
You're a correspondent. No, that I know. I have no clue what y'all are going to be throwing at me when it happens.
All right, guys. Well, I'm going to be getting off. Me and Julie are going to get off. So you all have a great night.
Yeah, I bet you are.
Yeah. There it is.
See you, everybody.
I set it up. You knocked it down.
Yeah, baby.
Good night, guys.
Later, guys.
I gotta move tomorrow. See ya.
Rest well. I'm raiding you guys over to Designation V, who seems to be doing Kingdom Hearts. I don't recognize what I'm watching is Kingdom Hearts, though. I don't know what this is. It might be the Tron levels or some shit. Either way, Thank you guys so much for watching. There will be more of this, more streams to come. Really looking forward to coming back. Put a bunch of emote spams and blahs in chat when you go into the raid. And I will see you guys on Halloween night. Bye-bye.